providing Norsworthy with counseling and hormone therapy. Patrick Foss, SRN News.
Connecticut State Police are investigating the death of a 26-year-old man who died last night after a Hartford police officer used a taser to subdue him when he allegedly became combative during a medical assistance call. This is SRN News. New York Mayor Bill de Blasio says the Legionnaires' disease outbreak in the Bronx is under control.
We can say with confidence that this outbreak has been contained. We can say with confidence that every pertinent city agency is at full bore right now using all of its resources to address the situation.
The mayor says some 150 investigators have been examining cooling towers in the buildings in the Bronx in an effort to combat the disease.
The cooling tower is not a traditional New York City water tower. It's not the wooden tower on top of a building you get water from. Cooling tower is a modern mechanical feature associated with a HVAC system.
10 people have died, over 100 people sickened in the South Bronx since the outbreak was first reported. The Panama Canal will temporarily limit the size of ships using the waterway because drought has lowered water levels in two lakes. The restrictions will take effect beginning September the 8th. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Hey, Berkey Guy here. Are you still drinking unfiltered tap water? Does your water contain chlorine or fluoride? Will you have drinkable water in an emergency? The Berkey Guy is here to help you remove these and other potential contaminants from your water, thus helping you drink clean, purified water. We offer Berkey water purification systems at the lowest available prices online. Don't go another moment without Berkey system. Over the last 10 years, we've helped thousands drink clean, purified water. Join them by visiting goberkey.com or call me, the Berkey Guy, at 877-886-3653. That's 877-886-3653.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Welcome to Free Talk Live. It is the live Saturday edition. You can join us here on the radio waves. The us includes me, Ian.
And me, Mark.
We've got on the way here some audio. If we get the chance of the John and Kat Bleich, they're friends of the show. We've had them on. John and Kat were here actually on a Bitcoin tour most recently, a couple of months ago now, I think at this point, maybe 2 or 3 months ago. And they got pulled over recently in Austin, Texas, and they did a pretty good job of exercising their rights, especially considering they actually had their kids with them at the time, and their children were terrified of the police who had pulled them over. I'll play that when we get the chance. But there's also other news that is in relation to police pullovers, specifically the use of drug dogs on the side of the road. And went to the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Seventh Circuit, where, according to Radley Balco over at the Washington Post, they issued a troubling ruling about drug dogs. U.S. versus Bentley is just the latest in a series of rulings in which the federal courts refuse to consider the possibility that police departments may be manipulating the dogs to authorize unlawful searches. Well, our officers would never. I mean, that would suggest that there would be dishonest police, and we couldn't possibly suggest to people that the police, who are their paladins of justice, would for a moment consider doing something so dastardly.
Well, you sound pretty biased when you read all this, and especially with the intro. What I believe is going on here is that dogs are trained in order to alert on drugs. They're trained with a treat or, you know, the ball they like or whatever it is. And they want to make you happy. By you, I mean
the trainer.
The handler, right? Yeah. And, you know, alerting makes the handler happy because the handler then gets to look in whatever it is.
That's right. And then the handler gives them a treat.
Right.
Or the ball.
So, sometimes they don't alert. I've had a drug dog, go over my stuff. They didn't alert. Mm. It really depends largely, and they've done studies on this, it depends largely on what the handler believes. If the handler believes that there's something in the bag, the dog is more likely to alert because, well, I mean, they're man's best friend. They've been with us for hundreds of thousands of years. They can read us better than we can read ourselves. And so if the guy thinks there's something, if the handler thinks, the handler may be male or female, believes there's something in the bag, then, you know, the dog's going to pick up on that, and they're going to try to make their handler happy.
You sound like a conspiracy theorist, Mark.
That's conspiracy Our theory?
Officers would never do those things on purpose.
Obviously, people have beliefs. I mean, who thinks that an officer doesn't walk into a situation believing one way or the other about a particular bag or area? I mean, who thinks that? If you just take a dog and you walk him through the train, as I've had my most recent drug search, you know, the officer's probably not going to think anything particular about the people as they walk past. But if you've got somebody standing there with, I don't know, a big tie-dye pot leaf T-shirt on and long hair and the little round sunglasses, you know, like maybe the officer is going to believe that person might have cannabis on them. And if they come to that conclusion in their mind, then the dog's going to alert. This is why dogs are very good at deciding whether or not the officer believes the person has drugs, but that's not what the dogs are there for.
So the courts refused to consider the possibility that the department could be manipulating the dog or the officer could manipulate the dog to authorize unlawful searches, or at the very least that police agencies aren't ensuring the dogs are being trained to minimize that possibility, even though that would be easy to do. The problem with drug-sniffing dogs is not that dogs aren't capable of sniffing out drugs. It's that we've bred into domestic dogs a trait that trumps that ability, a desire to read us and to please us.
Yeah, yeah, it's like I read this article.
Yeah, have you?
No, but I have read the research on this particular subject.
If a drug dog isn't specifically trained to compensate for this, it will merely read its handler's body language and confirm its handler's suspicions about who is and who isn't hiding drugs. And think about this. You know, if you get pulled over and you don't have drugs, now, first of all, you don't know whether there are drugs in your car, right? If you have any family members or friends who have been riding in your car at some point, whether you were there or not, they could have stashed some drugs in your car.
Anything could have happened. Or they could have fallen out.
Sure. Fallen down in the seat crack or whatever. And you don't know. Okay, so just because you're consenting to a search, which I don't recommend that you do, and I'm not
under no circumstances should you do that.
Yeah, but you know, you don't know what they're going to find, and then all of a sudden, oh look, they found your buddy's stash of marijuana. Well, you didn't know that was there. That's not going to stop them from charging you criminally with possessing that marijuana.
Let's talk about searching a vehicle real quick. The good American patriotic thing to do is to refuse a search. Here's why. Not only are these the rights that people have fought and died for in this country, but you're wasting that police officer's time. If you don't have drugs in that car, you just tell them, hey, officer, really, there's better things for you to be doing. There's no drugs here. And that way, what you're doing as a citizen is you're putting that police officer back on the street so they can go do some better work. Now, if that officer somehow disagrees with you, like, this is the best thing I can be doing right now, that officer is, wait for it, wrong, okay? Right? And police officers that are wrong enough should be given negative consequences for that. If you do not give negative consequences to people in this world, they will not learn.
What's the negative consequence for the officer?
Being told no. These people are, you know, not used to being told no.
That's true.
People will unwisely and unpatriotically say, sure, I've got nothing to hide. Well, that's a dumb reason to let somebody search your vehicle. If you have nothing to hide, put that officer back on the streets so they can go and find somebody who is breaking a law.
You may
committing a crime against someone.
Right. You may have nothing to hide, but you also probably have better things to do than have your car tossed.
Some people don't. Some people have nothing better to do than let a police officer search their car and then put it back together on the side of the road.
You're the one who has to do that. They won't do that for you in a lot of cases.
In some cases, they will.
I've never heard about that case, but
I'm sure some officer would feel contrite for tossing your car
probably is
and attempt to put it back together for you.
But, Mark, you know, in order for an officer to toss your car in the first place, they have to be a real a-hole. So I don't know if they'd be likely to put it all back together for you.
They're going to have to look. I mean, when you're looking through something, you have to dig through it, right? And
but they don't have to look. They can choose not to.
They can.
And if they're insisting or
it's
if they're
their job to
illegally
look,
searching, because some of them will ignore what you want and they'll just go ahead and do it anyway. And no, Mark, it is not their job to look. It is their job to catch criminals doing, you know, criminal activity. Now, they will define criminal activity differently than you and I would. I don't think it's criminal unless somebody actually gets hurt, unless there's a victim. And in the case of possessing drugs, there is no victim. So, you know, as far as I'm concerned, the police don't need to be doing that at all. It's a waste of their time.
You did not ask me whether or not I thought that police should be doing that. It is their job.
Their job is to use discretion.
It's what their employers tell them they should do.
Not everywhere. In fact, it doesn't really seem to happen here in New Hampshire very often. I've never heard of it. I mean, I'm not saying it doesn't happen here. It probably does. But, you know, I've been here for nearly a decade. I've got a lot of people who are friends of mine who've been pulled over at various different points. And the only time I've ever heard of a search being asked about was somebody who got pulled over in Vermont, not New Hampshire. Now, I'm not saying it doesn't happen, but I think that there are some departments, Mark, that have different strategies and different things that are priorities over others. Like, for instance, here in the Keene area in New Hampshire, I know they give out a lot of warnings. We certainly know that there are departments where it's not, you know, they're not told to warn people. They're told to ticket and ticket as often as they possibly can because it's all about revenue for those other departments. In New Hampshire, the local police do not get revenue from the tickets that they write. So their incentives are a little bit different. So to just say across the board that it's their job to toss people's cars, that's not true. I've not seen that as true in everywhere.
It's their job if their bosses tell them it's their job.
And even if their bosses tell them, it's still their job to use discretion, and so they can go out on the streets and ignore their boss.
The average citizen is the boss that is superior to the police officer's boss, right? Well, that's the concept, right? That's the story we're told in civics class. And if you believe,
as far as it goes.
If you believe that story we were told in civics class, it is your job to help that officer reallocate their time in a more efficient fashion. And the best way you can help that officer reallocate their time in a more efficient fashion is to say, look, officer, there's nothing in this car. The best thing for you to do is to go about your business. I'm going to refuse your search now. Please, let me go. Am I free to go? Am I being detained?
855-450-FREE is our number. 855-450-3733. More about this court ruling coming up. It's Free Talk Live.
If you could choose any school in the country to earn your college degree and be on your way to a better life, would you choose one the Wall Street Journal recognizes as producing some of the best qualified graduates? Or one the Princeton Review ranks as a leader in undergraduate education? Or maybe one the U.S. News & World Report names among the most innovative schools in the country? Now, you don't have to choose. At Arizona State University, we want to help you learn to thrive in life. At ASU Online, we offer over 100 graduate and undergraduate programs on your time and schedule. You receive the exact same curriculum, degree, and prestigious faculty as the on-campus students, and we're universally recognized as one of the innovators in online learning technologies. For information, call 1-800-595-9736. U.S. News & World Report ranked ASU in the top 10 best places to earn an online degree. So learn to thrive with ASU Online. Call today at 1-800-595-9736. That's 1-800-595-9736.
Again, the Congressional Budget Office sounds the alarm. This time warns of Greek-style U.S. debt crises. You heard me right. The GAO is drawing a parallel between the U.S. economy, its debt, and the current Greek economic meltdown. With the debt-to-GDP chart climbing into unfamiliar territory, the growing budget deficit will rise to unsupportable levels. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. The Federal Debt and Risk of Financial Crises document the CBO has published is a must-read for every American. Covering the risk of continued deficit spending coupled with an aging population and the rising interest rates spell economic disaster. It's imperative that you get a copy of this document and study it for yourself. Call me today at 800-686-2237, and I'll send you a free copy. Again, call 800-686-2237 and ask for your copy of the CBO document. Once again, you need to read this government report. Call 800-686-2237.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from hiddenholster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to hiddenholster.com. That's hiddenholster.com. The original hidden holster.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com. SupernaturalSilver.com and use the promo code Silver2015 for 30% off of your entire order and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. You can join us right here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Drug dogs, they are in the news over on the Washington Post site. Radley Balco, who does a really great job of kind of keeping up with the police state in America, is following a federal court decision, the appeals court of the Seventh Circuit, issuing a troubling ruling about drug dogs last week. We'll tell you more about it here in a moment. Our number is 855-450-FREE.
I hold in my hand the solution to Obamacare. At least it was in my household. It's Liberty HealthShare. It's a movement in healthcare today. It's a movement of people that are ready to stand up and take charge of their own healthcare decisions. It's people like you and me who are tired of paying too much for healthcare and getting too little. People who are standing up for their values and letting their conscience make their decision based on timeless principles. It's a movement that's sweeping the nation, and you need to be part of it. Liberty HealthShare is leading the movement of people who are looking for an alternative to traditional health insurance. For our household, it was like half the cost of health insurance. I spoke to my wife about it. She looked at the costs and everything, and pulled out the paperwork for what we'd been quoted previously, and that was our experience. Liberty HealthShare is a healthcare sharing organization of people who are sharing the cost of healthcare in an easy and efficient way. You can choose your own doctor, choose your own hospital, live out your values in healthcare, join the movement, and let's change healthcare for good. LibertyHealthShare.org. It's 1-855-58-LIBERTY. LibertyHealthShare.org, 855-58-LIBERTY.
So we're talking about this Seventh Circuit Court, U.S. Court of Appeals, in a drug dog case, U.S. versus Bentley. This according to Radley Balco at the Washington Post. A little bit more info, and then we'll jump into your calls and thoughts here. Balco's pointing out that a dog, since they're pack animals, they are interested in pleasing you as the alpha if you have positioned yourself in that way, and certainly a police trainer does. So they want to read you and to please you, and unless the dog is trained to compensate for that natural ability, it'll do that. It'll essentially do what the handler is wanting it to do, basically. It has been confirmed by tests of canine units that have shown that controlled tests designed to fool the handlers are much more likely to trigger false alerts than controlled tests designed to fool the dogs. So if you can get the handler to think that there's drugs in something, yep, the dog will react. The fact that mind-sniffing dogs, as in minds that blow up, tend to be more accurate than their drug-sniffing cousins further illustrates the point. Handlers not only have fewer preconceptions about where minds are located, but they also have an incredibly strong incentive for the dogs to be accurate about finding them. But even here, the dog-handler bond can become problematic, which is why some detection experts are turning to rats. The problem is that invasive searches based on no more than a government official's hunch is precisely what the Fourth Amendment is supposed to guard against. Unfortunately, the way the U.S. Supreme Court has ruled on this issue not only doesn't account for the problem, but also has given police agencies a strong incentive to ensure that drug dogs aren't trained to act independently of their handler's suspicions. A dog prone to false alerts means more searches, which means more opportunities to find and seize cash and other lucre under asset forfeiture policies.
Right. It doesn't, you know, the police department isn't harmed if somebody is searched, you know.
Falsely.
Falsely. Yeah, falsely is a good term.
Right. There's no consequence for the officer in question. There's no consequence for the department. The only consequence is for you and your inconvenience of not getting to where it was you were going to go and you having your rights, your right to privacy, violated. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. We also have Skype. You may Skype into the show at username lrn.fm. Let's go to Scott first. He's in Panama City. Scott, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, Ian and Mark. How are you guys doing today?
Welcome,
hey,
sir.
I had a quick question. You know, I haven't had instances where I've had, you know, police officers that have asked me to search my vehicle. You know, I've had an incident one time where I had was on a military base or going through a military base on a highway and had an officer that I was speeding. It was about 1 o'clock in the morning. I was coming back from Tampa Bay, Florida. But anyway, he went to pull me over, and, you know, I've always been taught, you know, slow down and pull over at the first safest right-hand turn that you can pull over to. And I did, and I guess that really irritated the officer. Well, you know, when he came up to the vehicle, I mean, he was just hateful. And, you know, my philosophy is you come up, you give me respect, I'll give you respect back. Long story short, it just got to a point where he was just getting really belligerent with me. And I told him, I said, well, I'll tell you what's going to happen. I'm going to roll up my window. You need to call your superior officer, and as soon as your superior officer gets down here, then we will continue to have this conversation. But anyway, you know, what do you do if you're in a situation where you get an officer that pulls you over and wants to search your vehicle, and you tell them no? You know, what are your rights in that instance?
Well, okay, so first really of all, I'm not an attorney, but here's my suggestion based on, you know, on my experience in dealing with police as a cop block agent. And I would say the number one thing to do is record the situation and make sure the officer knows he's being recorded, because in a lot of cases, just that knowledge will change how the outcome of the situation transpires, how the officer is behaving throughout the scene. And so if you are telling an officer no and you're also recording, well, then it's on the record, right? That officer can't say later on, unless he smashes your camera and beats you, the officer can't say later on that you allowed him to search, because it's now been caught on the record. And so, therefore, if he proceeds to search anyway, even without your permission, he is violating, essentially, he's violating the rules. I mean, they can't search without asking unless they have probable cause to search. And if they have probable cause, he won't ask you. So by virtue of the fact that he's asking to search means that he does not have any real reason to do so beyond a hunch.
The next thing you need to say if they are demanding a search is look, you know, they can't hold you past the normal time for a ticket. So
if, that's right. There's
just
a recent
because you're
Supreme
having
Court
a conversation
ruling
doesn't mean you're required to be there. So what you need to say is no for the search. I would like to depart now. Am I being detained?
Yeah, or am I free to go?
Am I free to go? Am I being detained? Because if they don't want to, they need to answer that question. If they haven't answered that question, then, you know, you are officially allowed to go. They just need to, they need to answer that question. I wouldn't pull away until I get an answer, though. And I would have
right,
that on video, too.
Right. I guess why I'm asking is because, you know, in my mind, I think that, you know, if an officer tells me, you know, they want to search my vehicle, in my mind, I'm thinking, well, really, they kind of have that right to.
They do not.
No, they do not.
So that's why I was kind of asking the question, because I really wasn't certain. And I'm sure there are probably a lot of people out there that feel the same way that I do, that, you know, if an officer says, well, I'd like to search your vehicle, are you going to give me permission? You know, I feel like, well, I really don't have an option here.
You absolutely do have an option.
It's supposed to feel that way.
Yeah, that's why they'll have to. That's why they say things. They're very, very careful with how they word these
things. I'm going to have to ask you to step out of your car now.
Or I'm going to have to ask to search your car. And the way he says it with his hand on his gun, makes it seem like it's not asking. But he's actually, in point of fact, asking. I'm going to have to ask you. So what he's saying there is, well, sir, I do not have any probable cause to search your car, so by my protocols, I'm going to have to ask you to search because I can't do it on my own. I need your permission. And anytime they ask you to search, just say no. Scott, thanks for your call tonight, man. I appreciate it. Good luck out there on the roads. I know it's not easy down in Florida. Those cops can be pretty nasty, and they're everywhere. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. You can share your experiences on the side of the road. It's Free Talk Live.
Measles is activating on a mass scale, now due to the vaccines and iron poisoning. All symptoms, disease, and deaths are due to measles and iron, not just rash and flu-like symptoms, as the officials claim. Measles requires a host with iron to replicate. Iron intake is at an unprecedented level. Deaths and hospitalizations are set to soar now in 2015. This is the extermination plan, people. For further information, go to unveilingthem.com. UnveilingThem.com. Unveilingthem.com.
Now a twice as nice twin kit special offer from Complete H2O Minerals for all GCN listeners. Get a Complete H2O Minerals twin kit with 33 different minerals, vitamins, and amino acids all in a liquid form. Enough for two people for 1 month. Regular price $89.95, but now Complete H2O Minerals is offering the twin kit for $69.95. And all GCN listeners receive a bonus 16-ounce bottle of ionic silver absolutely free with free shipping. A $120 total value. Hurry, limited time offer. Call 803-794-4767 or click CompleteH2OMinerals.com.
Mike Stenerson for Midas Resources. At no time in history have precious metals been more important, certainly not in my 22 years in the industry. The dollar has lost over 90% of its value in the last 60 years. No fiat currency has ever survived the government printing presses. Ours is not immune. The time is now to be proactive. 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Anything tied to the dollar is at risk. CDs, annuities, 401ks, IRAs, stocks, bonds, you name it, so decide. Do you want to leave a legacy of wealth or debt for your family? The choice is yours. Call me at 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. That's 1-800-686-2237, extension 116. Be proactive, not reactive. Call 1-800-686-2237, extension 116.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the free...
Is there some sort of emergency? Yes.
Would you mind... Sorry?
I think it's fine how it is. Yes.
Would you mind rolling your window down all the way? Sorry?
Sort of emergency.
Your registration is expired as of January. Okay. Your license and proof of insurance, please.
The car's insured, but I haven't received the.
Received the email.
I haven't received or. I don't think I need to answer that question.
Let me find where I put my phone.
I don't.
Okay, you can pull it up.
Can I use your phone?
Yeah, let me find where I put my phone.
I don't think I need question. Well, I'm not obliged to answer it, so I'm gonna go ahead and Terry V, Ohio, it's a classic.
Well, it's a paperwork issue. We live in pull your vehicle over. Don't be afraid.
Last name Bush, boy Union, Sam Henry. First name John, J-O-H-N, Sam Henry.
She said she pulled us over because our registration... Every year you have to pay the government money to drive.
In toll free, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
This is Free Talk Live. We're here. It's a live Saturday edition of the program. You can join us on the radio waves here and bring up anything that happens to be on your mind. It doesn't have to be police searches. Drug dogs, specifically, there's been a court case out of the Seventh Circuit Court of Appeals that we're going over. Radley Balco over at WashingtonPost.com with a piece. We'll continue with some of his points about it here in a moment. Basically, you know, focusing on the fact that these drug dogs have been proven with, you know, independent studies that, you know, these guys aren't accurate. They're just not accurate at finding drugs. They're more accurate at doing what their handler wants them to do, which of course is alert to drugs, even if there aren't any drugs there. Because, well, if a dog alerts on a car, then that gives the handler the excuse that they need legally to search the car and then find who knows what, and possibly write you up with all manner of different citations you wouldn't have otherwise received.
I kind of feel bad the way you phrased it. The dogs aren't doing anything wrong. The dogs are doing what they're trained to do.
Isn't that what I said?
What they get rewarded to do. Well, you're accurate. They're accurate in deciding what it is that their handler wants.
Right, they're accurate in pleasing their handler. And
which is what any dog wants to do, right?
So we're talking about that. You can also bring up what you want here at 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. If you're getting online through your home, your work internet connection, your phone, you are not protected by default from people who might want to, let's say, save your surfing history, like your own internet service provider is probably doing right now. Saving all the websites you go to, the search terms you're entering, maybe keeping those logs for several years, criminals sniffing out your Wi-Fi packets. You can foil those people by getting ProXPN. It's a global virtual private network, and you can go to proxpn.com/FTL, where you'll save 50% off the regular monthly price for the lifetime of the account when you buy an annual account with our discount code, which is FTL50. That's FTL like Free Talk Live, and 50 as in 50% off. And that breaks down the price to about $5 per month. And that gives you unlimited bandwidth, servers around the world you can access. You can privately torrent and get past regionally blocked websites. You get it all with a risk-free 7-day money-back guarantee. Just get started right now over at proxpn.com/FTL. And use promo code FTL50 to get a great discount on privacy that is priceless. Let's continue with your calls and thoughts here. We go to Omar, listening in Albuquerque. Omar, you're on Free Talk Live, listening to Kiva.
Yeah, how you guys doing tonight?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Yeah, you know, I'm just preface this by saying I'm a former police officer, ex-graduated valedictorian of my academy class. And what you're talking about tonight is kind of pretty much a pet peeve of mine.
Hmm.
And that I hate seeing officers that go around or play the law to their advantage or people's lack of knowledge of it.
So you are not a fan of an officer trying to get consent to search?
I've never tried. Well, they do it all the wrong way, and I've never trusted the dogs anyway myself.
Mm-hmm.
What people don't understand is an officer cannot ask you if he can search until the stop is complete.
Really?
You have to have your copy of the citation, your driver's license. You have to have all of your information back before he can ask.
So that's interesting. I did not realize that. So what you're saying is when an officer asks you to search, you should have already gotten the ticket, and that is an indicator that this stop is over and that if your next question out of your mouth is, am I free to go, he should say yes.
Correct.
Interesting.
Now, when an officer asks to search, you never say yes or no. You simply say, am I free to go?
Mm. Yeah, because you're not obligated to answer his questions.
Correct. You don't get into the yes-no argument. You simply say, am I free to go? You put it back on the officer, but the stop has to be complete. They can't ask you while they're still in the middle of issuing you a citation if they are doing so.
Mm.
You have to have all of your documents back before he can ask. It has to be a totally separate incident.
Interesting.
What makes an officer ask? I have never had this asked of me.
Respectable.
I suppose that's what it is, but I mean, I'm a convicted felon. If they have something up on their computer right there, I see no reason why they wouldn't look me up. They've never asked me. They've asked friends of mine. And do you have any clue what makes them ask?
What makes them ask is just visual cues. Of course, most people are nervous in a stop anyway.
Sure.
So we're used to seeing that. But are they overly nervous? Do they keep glancing at a particular area in the vehicle? There are visual indicators that may cause you to ask. The second pet peeve of mine, and I've talked to friends who are attorneys, and the way I'm not happy with the drug dog issue myself. In the majority of states, if not all of them, a police dog is a commissioned officer. If you injure the dog, shoot the dog, attack the dog, you're going to be charged with the same penalties as you would a human officer.
It's a felony.
In Florida, I know that there's it's a third-degree felony for harming a police dog or horse. Maybe it's second.
Well, so here's the issue. When you deny consent to search to one officer, it extends to all officers from that point forward for that particular stop. A police dog, if you notice, and they walk around, they tap parts of the vehicle. They're directing the dog where to search.
Mm-hmm.
So now either the dog is an officer and you just turn it loose and it walks around on its own, or it's a tool used by the handler. In either case, once you've denied consent to search, it extends to all officers, including that dog. But nobody has ever attacked it in court from that angle.
Oh, that's interesting.
That's the way to beat it. They argue, is it a false, is it a hit, or what's wrong? But they've never brought up the argument. If the dog's an officer and I deny consent to search, then that extends to the dog as well.
Well, wouldn't they be arguing? I mean, I think that's an interesting approach, but wouldn't the police's argument counter to that be essentially that, well, the dog wasn't searching the vehicle, it was just sniffing the air around it, which is a legal thing to do?
Well, if it can do it without another officer's or handler's direction, more power to it. Then I don't have a problem with it. But if another officer is directing, tapping the vehicle where to sniff, then the dog is being used as a tool, and that officer is conducting an illegal search if you have not granted consent.
Good information, Omar. Is there anything else you want to share?
It's no different than the flashlights that have the built-in alcohol detector sensors in them.
Yeah, that's a sneaky move.
It's no different than that.
Omar, great call, man.
I really would like to see somebody attack it from that angle.
Thank you for bringing that up. I really appreciate it. Really useful information, and I thank you for it tonight. Appreciate the info.
It's always the ex-cops that have the best info.
They are great, man, and I appreciate that. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. So what he said was pretty useful, and I did not realize that was the case. It sounds right, though, right? Like the idea that they can't ask you to search legally. That doesn't mean that some cop won't violate the law, but legally, they're supposed to only ask that question once they've served you with your ticket or whatever it was you were initially pulled over for.
Anything they do wrong is no big deal unless you take it to a higher court anyway.
Yeah.
Unless you're taking it on up to appeals court. It doesn't really matter if it doesn't go any farther than that, because it doesn't count as far as the law is concerned.
And there's no consequence to them generally anyway for botching it up beyond maybe, you know, a nasty letter from the chief. In a lot of cases,
Tops.
It's about the worst that'll happen. 855-450-FREE. Let's go to Dan. He's in Newport, Virginia, listening to WNIS. Hello, Dan.
Hi. Thank you for taking my call.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
A few years ago, I was working as a reporter here in Newport News, so I don't know the policies of other cities. But I got to spend some good time with the police, like along the lines of what you'd do if you went to Citizens Academy or something like that. But one evening, a police officer explained to me that when they were working in high crime areas, high drug areas of the town, that they understand that most of the people don't know their rights. So the officer told me, he said, so I see this guy walking down the street. I know he's a bad guy, and I know he's dealing, so I know he's got drugs on him. So I go up to him, pull him over, and I also know that he doesn't know his rights. And so I ask him if I can search him. Well, he said, well, the bad guy in his mind figures that if I don't let him search me, he's going to get a search warrant. But if I do just go ahead and act like I'm innocent and let him search me, he's not going to find anything.
And that is a bad viewpoint to be coming from. If you want to continue telling your story, stand by, Dan. We'll come back to you. 855-450-FREE, Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
There are hundreds of silver products on the market today, but there's nothing like the astonishing health benefits of the multi-patented One Silver Solution. Boost your immune system at a great price with our Silver Solution Liquid, starting at $12.95 a bottle, now available in regular and extra strength. That's half the price of the leading competitors. Call 844-USILVER for your free catalog, or go to onesilversolution.com, onesilversolution.com. There is only one Silver Solution.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
She said she pulled us over because our registration's expired. Money to drive your car around. It's very strange. Thankfully, she seems very sweet and polite.
I'll be right back with you.
There's stickers on the car.
Where are we at?
Just south of like 34th Street. We're on Guadalupe.
Tell me where we are.
Up
Hold
to date.
Camera. Can you tell me where we are?
We expect you to have up
Hold
to
the
date.
Camera. Can you tell me where we are?
Nobody likes to be cool. And I hope that it won't always be like that.
I hope they don't see it.
Oh, baby. They're not gonna kill us. Don't worry. We're safe, okay? It's so weird that this is normal. Good thing we got our insurance updated.
Afraid of her.
You're afraid of her? Good timing. Good thing we got our insurance updated.
Now, more Free Talk Live. We continue here on the live Saturday edition of the show with you tonight. It's Ian here.
And Mark.
Don't forget to join us online. Just drop by freetalklive.com. Please enjoy the features we have for you there. You can enjoy them for free. There are archives going back a long way, almost a decade's worth of shows for free. You just go click and download, unlike those other talk show hosts that want to charge you for their sites. Go and enjoy over at freetalklive.com. We're talking about the police, specifically drug dog searches on the side of the road. Hopefully this hasn't happened to you. If it has, then you know what some of the real negative consequences can be from this. Even if you don't have drugs in your car, sometimes the best case if you have allowed the search, which is a terrible idea, you should always say no to a search. Or as our last officer pointed out, instead of saying yes or no, just simply ask the question back, am I free to go? Because the officer who just called into the show said that apparently once a cop asks you if he can search your car, that stop is over. The reason they stopped you, which was to possibly issue you some sort of a ticket, once they've issued you that ticket or that warning, stop's over. If you consent to a search, you're consenting to hang out with that officer for a little while longer and give him the chance to arrest you for something.
I'd still make sure I ask that question, am I free to go? Because you don't want a situation where, you know, the kid in South Carolina just this week got killed over 10 grams of marijuana because
oh
he was driving away from a stop
yeah.
when he hadn't been given permission by the police officer. The officer says, he's trying to hit me.
Yeah, if there's one question that you should have in your repertoire dealing with police, it's am I free to go? For sure. So we're going to continue with your calls and thoughts here. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. Dan is with us in Virginia. Dan, you are a reporter of some sort, journalist, and you were on a ride-along with some police there in Newport News in the past. And you were actually, one officer was honest with you enough to admit that he picks on people specifically because he figures they don't know their rights. People in poorer neighborhoods, for instance, he figures they don't know what the heck they're doing as far as their rights are concerned. So he's just going to walk all over them. Did you want to share more about that?
Yeah, well, first of all, that's absolutely correct how you said it. And but first of all, I'm not a reporter anymore.
Okay.
That was at that time. But anyway, yeah, well, he actually said that was the policy. It was not something he was.
It was policy to pick on people who don't know their rights?
Yeah, correct. If they think that they're the bad guy, yeah, to go ahead and pick on them because they pretty much know they don't know their rights. And it's the way he explained it, he said, you know, then we search him because the guy figures we're not going to find anything because he thinks he's smarter than us. And then we find the drugs and we have the arrest. And I ever since that happened, I haven't been able to get it out of my head. I thought, well, you wonder why we're having these riots? I may not experience that anger because I'm not getting pulled over for a search because I know my rights. But if you don't respect our rights from the beginning, there's just something very wrong here.
Yeah, it really just it really shows you the mentality of some of these officers. I'm not going to say they're all the way that this guy is, but the fact that this was departmental policy is very concerning.
Well, it's the reasonable outcome of this game, the game called the drug war.
Mm.
The reasonable outcome is when one side has very few consequences for sort of stepping beyond the law, and the other side has tremendous consequences.
Right.
You're going to see one side, behave entirely differently than the other side. And that's the problem.
Right.
The police and prosecutors and judges, they don't bear any responsibility for a bad search.
Anything else you want to share, Dan? Go ahead.
No, thank you for taking
Thanks for the call, man. I appreciate hearing from you. Let's go to Mike. He's in Myrtle Beach listening to WRNN. Hello, Mike.
How you doing? Thanks for taking the call.
Go for it.
Hey, I have something interesting to ask you, because I know this has happened to somebody. They were pulled over. Cop asked to search the vehicle. They said no. The cop impounded the vehicle. And took it back to the police station on a tow truck, on a flatbed.
It's my understanding that's unconstitutional.
I had that happen to a friend of mine, James Cleveland. Who,
how did they get away with doing that?
Well, that's the thing. They can kind of just do whatever they want to, and then if you don't call them on it later, they get away with it. So that tends to be especially how the more corrupt police act is, well, we'll just throw it up against a wall and we'll see what sticks. And, most of the time, especially if they're dealing with people who don't know their rights, the people who don't know their rights don't know their rights have been violated when they're violated, and they don't know what to do about it, even if they do know. You know, they may not be able to afford an attorney. No attorneys in town may want to go up against the police department. So there are a variety of reasons why people just sort of move on once their rights have been violated.
Well, it's emotionally taxing to deal with law enforcement and that sort
sure.
of thing too. I mean, who wants to deal with this? Once it's done, let's just be done. You know, it stinks. It stinks having to deal with with court.
When you're on the side of the road, can they get a search warrant and then do it?
In theory, they could,
but they can't hold you longer than the normal amount of time to
write
to
ticket.
Write the ticket. So,
but you got to define what is the normal amount of time.
Agreed. And the highest court, the Supreme Court, has refused to do that. And sadly, they, you know, like it, it should be
so
20 minutes is what they should say.
For a week.
Right.
It's crazy.
I'm not saying that the system isn't broken. You know, as a matter of fact, I've been saying just the opposite for a very long time.
Well, because if it ever happens to me, I want to know what my rights are in a situation like that.
Well, hopefully the officer.
What I can do about it.
Yeah, so hopefully the officer we just had on can help a little bit with that.
I don't want my car getting ripped apart either in some tow yard somewhere.
Yeah, I mean, you can't control what a rogue cop's going to do, okay? The only thing.
Or a rogue department.
Or a rogue department. You can only control how you handle the situation. And as I said before, and it's worth saying again. Record the scene, whatever it is that goes on. I realize if they're going to try to take the car away and search it in secret, you obviously won't be able to record something like that. But do your best to assert your desire to observe that searching process go on, because certainly it is possible they could plant something in your car. That's not unheard of when it comes to these corrupt officers. If they're willing to, you know, to lie, if they're willing to force their way into searching your car, they're certainly willing to plant something in there. So, really, all you can do is assert your rights, assert them on video, and then later on, lawyer up when the time comes. Certainly, you don't want to admit to anything. Don't answer their questions. You're not obligated to do that. This isn't legal advice. It's just some suggestions based on experience. And I would also recommend dropping into copblock.org when you get a chance. They've got some really good information about your rights and how to assert them. And thank you, Mike, for your call tonight. Good luck out there. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. If you're dealing with the police who are willing to violate their own rules, to violate the law in order to get a conviction, then there's the only thing you can do is be on the defensive when the time comes, and that is, you know, not roll over, don't take the plea deal, find some attorneys who care about rights and, you know, try to get them on your side. But this is a costly process, and I don't blame anybody for just wanting it to go away or, you know, taking a plea deal. Ultimately, taking a plea deal in these cases is not helping. That encourages, it doesn't help you and the rest of us. It encourages the police to do what they're doing because they know they can get away with it.
Well, the plea deal system itself is corrupt. I mean, it's a terrible system. It is a way for, the only people it benefits are guilty people and prosecutors who want to continue to run their numbers up, and police, I suppose, to some extent. But I mean, it benefits the system, which is there to serve us, right? The system is supposed to serve justice. And if it doesn't serve justice, it's broken. And so when you're talking about a system where fewer than 1% of people go on to get a trial, and only one-third of them gets found not guilty, you know you have a broken system that is designed to run innocent people through the grist mill of government bureaucracy.
That's what it's designed to do, Mark, so it's not broken. It's doing that very, very well. It's running people through
you
that
mill. You accept that? The average radio listener does not.
Oh, I don't like it, but that's just how it is. I mean, this system isn't designed to protect you. It's designed to protect the politicians who set it up. It's designed to protect the attorneys who are profiting from it.
Well,
it's designed to protect the police from any kind of responsibility for their actions.
When you say
and it's doing very well at those
when
things.
When you say politician, you distinguish between attorneys, but that's what we have here. We have
not in New Hampshire so much. In New Hampshire,
49 other states, right. In Washington, D.C., 90%+ of the politicians in the United States are lawyers. It's a lawyer industrial complex set up to stuff money in the pockets
of
lawyers.
So stop playing into their game and saying that it's set to serve you. It's not. It's not set to serve you. It's set to take from you. It's set to extract your wealth and extract your obedience until the point where you can barely take it anymore. I mean, that's as far as they can push it, is to the point where you can just barely take it anymore. Because if you get pushed beyond that point, well, you might have a violent revolution or something like that. So they're very cautious about how far they push. And
that's
what
because
they can
they're
get
a
away
monopoly.
With.
If it wasn't, if it was otherwise, you just leave the company, right? Like if a company gives you bad customer service, you just leave it.
All right, we got more coming up here, including some audio from some people who are asserting their rights on the side of the road. We'll give you a little example of what that can be like. And it's not an easy thing to do. Hour number two is coming up, 855-450-FREE.
Are you searching for your soulmate? Someone you can trust, who will never betray you or cooperate with the NSA? Stop searching. With Easy DNS, you found a keeper. Easy DNS does it all. Domain names, web hosting, and managed WordPress hosting. Easy DNS stands up for your internet freedom, and with servers in Canada, they do not cooperate with the NSA. Go to EasyDNS.com. You'll love their services or get a full refund. They guarantee it. And they accept Bitcoin. That's EasyDNS.com.
For over 75 years, GEICO's kept an eye on the future, keeping customers happy with things like 24/7 customer support and emergency roadside service. And to prove it, here's one of our commercials from over 75 years ago.
At GEICO, we promise to always find innovative new ways to serve you. In fact, we're so innovative, in 75 years, they'll listen to this old radio commercial and think, wow, they were innovative.
Wow, we are innovative.
GEICO, saving people money for over 75 years.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods?
Insurance up daily. Good thing we got our insurance up daily.
You're afraid of her? The police?
Where? Oh, there's somebody standing there? What's your name? And your badge number?
7553.
How are you tonight? Fine. Did you hear that my daughter said she was afraid of you?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
You could step closer.
We were asking if you just heard my daughter ask if you guys were going to kill us. No, the window's down or not down, so I can't hear what she's saying. Yeah, that's what our three-year-old, that's what she asks when people with guns approach our car because of all the media stuff, so just be aware. Absolutely not. Tell her absolutely not. Yeah, absolutely not, Aliana. Sorry that so many.
She probably has little kids too, like you. Well, police can be scary.
She's probably not gonna miss you. Because she's the police.
I don't know police's names.
Officer McCoy. Did you notice? What, does she run the plate or something? Does she have a license plate reader on that thing?
Why is she stealing?
Because she's making sure that we're not doing anything crazy. Police, my ID. They're working together to see, make sure each other. Lady? Why, is she creepy?
No, that girl.
Oh, this girl?
Is your license back?
I think she's going to give us a warning because she doesn't want to take us. My daughter thinks you're creepy. License, yes.
Is that your current physical address?
That's my permanent.
Serious?
No, her partner, the one that's running my working together to see.
You seem nice so far. Okay, sir. Is this the current address on your... Okay, sir. Is this the current address on your...
Yes. Yes.
Okay. Would you mind rolling your window down all the way, please?
I think it's fine how it is.
I'm sorry?
I think it's fine how it is.
Okay. Do you know why I pulled you over?
I don't. Is there some sort of emergency?
Your registration is expired as of January.
Let me find where I put my phone. I don't think I need to answer that question. I don't see what it would help.
Yeah, I mean, it might, you know, if you're coming from, say, a bad neighborhood or a bar or just somewhere totally benign. It's just a question.
Well, I'm not obliged to answer it, so I'm going to go ahead and exercise my right to remain silent.
Okay, that's fine. Just so you know, you're not under arrest, but you are detained.
Terry V, Ohio. It's a classic.
Hey, Mama.
I'm looking for where my phone is.
Well, it's a paperwork issue. We live in a country where... Oh, Ollie has a phone. We live in a country where if you don't have your paper over... Don't be afraid.
She said she pulled us over because our registration's expired. Every year you had to pay the government money to drive your car around. It's very strange. Thankfully, she seems very sweet and polite. Because there's stickers on the car that the government expects you to have up to date. Nobody likes to be pulled over. It's an unfortunate part of the world that we live in right now, Ollie. And I hope that it won't always be like that.
I hope they don't
Oh, baby. They're not gonna kill us. Don't worry. We're safe, okay? Good thing we got our insurance updated.
What God was telling me.
Good timing. You're afraid of her?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Anna.
I'm afraid of that girl.
The police?
Yeah, that girl right there. Ow.
Where? Oh, there's somebody standing there? What's your name? And your badge number?
553.
How are you tonight?
I'm good, how are you?
Fine. Did you hear that my daughter said she was afraid of you?
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
You could
on your license?
Staring at us.
Give us a warning because she doesn't want to take us through the rigmarole of the municipal court.
You gotta say why.
I'm going to be honest, I don't appreciate that there's a girl Acevedo.
So
I'd rather
for this court date.
What happens if I don't sign?
You are being cited for the registration.
I'm gonna meet her quota.
I'm gonna have to call my supervisor out here and he's gonna tell you to sign the ticket. I'm gonna call my supervisor. Are you gonna sign the citation, sir?
I generally don't sign contracts under. Give me the ticket.
I'm supposed to be there to protect and serve. You're not serving my family right now. In fact, why would you choose to make someone's life more difficult?
Questions or concerns?
Yeah, I know the routine.
And if you get it taken care of within 10 days,
I know how it works.
A very minimal fee of $10. Okay? Do you have any more questions for
me? They're not going to take this to jail. I'm sorry they threatened.
No, just a suggestion to consider a new line of work that isn't parasitic, that the majority of the Austin public
doesn't
appreciate.
It doesn't cause three-year-olds to think they're going to be killed.
Launching into the second hour of the program. It's the live Saturday edition, continuing now. We started in the first hour discussing the Federal Appeals Court of the Seventh Circuit that has issued a troubling ruling about drug dogs last week. We got started on the story from the Washington Post. Radley Balco, the author, great guy, does a lot of good work kind of following along the horrifying progress of this police state in which we find ourselves. With you in the studio tonight, it's Ian.
And Mark.
If you want to join the discussion, our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. We've actually had a former cop call in the last hour, giving some really useful information. He says that if the cops ask you if they can search, that's an indicator the stop is over, that legally they're not supposed to be asking to search until after they've issued you a warning or a ticket for the reason they pulled you over. And at that point, you can say, am I free to go? Of course, you can ask that at any point you want. You can ask if I'm free to go, and then they will have to tell you yes. Because if you if they're asking you to search, they don't have the probable cause they need to actually go ahead and search without asking you. So the fact that they're asking you is an indicator that they don't have any reason to search you in the first place. So they're looking for your help in convicting you of something. Now remember, maybe you're not a drug user. Maybe you think you're in the clear. And you just figure you're going to go ahead and let them search because you're a good citizen and they're asking you and they're the police. Well, you might end up with a criminal charge anyway. Because what if somebody you know has left drugs in your car? Whoops. Now you're the one who gets to defend that in court. How's that going to be?
A lot of people's solution for this is to federalize the police, but I would warn you that the FBI is the only policing organization in the country that they don't even make audio or video recordings of their interviews.
It's true.
They just take notes, and this is what Martha Stewart was convicted on. She was sent to prison for a year for lying to a FBI agent when the only proof that she lied are some written notes taken by
those agents.
Is crazy, and you do not want an organization that puts up with that crap to be in charge of policing in this country.
Yeah, I would say centralizing police power is not a solution to the problem of police abuse.
Well, the best customer service generally comes from companies that are in competition.
Yeah. So let's go. We're going to continue with your calls and thoughts, but then more about this appeals court decision. And I've got audio of a couple people who do know their rights. Because we heard from a former reporter in the last hour. He said that a cop actually admitted to him that it's departmental policy, and apparently, allegedly, in Newport News, Virginia, to pick on people who don't know their rights. I mean, that makes sense.
Or was when he took the ride along.
I suspect it still is the policy, because that's how you can get away with stuff. You know, you can get away with searching people without a legal reason to do so. When you charge somebody who doesn't know their rights, they're likely to just take the plea deal. They're not likely to lawyer up. They just want it to be over so they can get back to going to work and taking care of their family. And so there's a lot we can say about this. But let's go first to Mark in San Diego. Mark, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and a different Mark.
Oh, hi. I hope you can hear me well.
Yes, sir.
Okay. I was going to make a comment that I hear a lot of people say. They go, am I free to go? Am I being detained? There is no legal definition for detainment that the police can use. They don't have an authority to detain people. They only have an authority to arrest people.
Well, hold on.
That's not my understanding.
Yeah, so what happens when you're pulled over on the side of the road getting a ticket?
You are under arrest the minute the lights went on.
Okay.
That's I've never heard this legal theory.
You're no longer under arrest when the lights when
the minute that those lights turned on, you are under arrest at that moment. Yeah. I've already had this discussion with an attorney and a judge.
Okay.
And they both said, you are under arrest at that moment in time. When you sign that ticket, you are released from arrest and allowed to go as long as you appear. Because if you don't appear, they're going to put a swear a warrant.
They don't make me sign tickets in New Hampshire.
Well, in California, they do.
And in a lot of places, they certainly do. But so if I'm not signing a ticket, then does that mean that I'm being detained or arrested?
Well, from everything that I've ever looked at, I have never been able to find any legal standing for detainment, that anyone can detain and hold anybody. They can arrest you and they can release you. So in California, I've been stopped before. I ask them if I'm under arrest. They say no. I say, thank you. I'm free to go. If they say no, then you go, am I under arrest? They go, no, okay, I'm leaving. Goodbye. And I've driven off. I have not had a single problem.
So, thanks, Mark, for your call tonight. I appreciate hearing from you. I don't necessarily agree. In my research that I've done, the detention is the in-between between being free and arrested. Detention is where they put you when they're trying to come up with a reason to arrest you, but they don't yet quite have it at that point. But here's a quick.
I don't think there's anything particularly, you know, like if you're willing to try out his theory, you know, like, am I under arrest? No. Well, then I'm leaving. If you declare that you're leaving, I think it gives them an opportunity to say whatever it is that they're going to say about you leaving. And, you know, so I can kind of see where he's coming from on it.
The differences between detention and an arrest is according to freeadvice.com.
It is worth every penny.
Are important because your rights change drastically from one to the other. In a detention, the police only need reasonable suspicion to stop an individual, and a reasonable person would feel as though they could leave in a short amount of time. This time frame can vary a bit based on the circumstances, but the U.S. Supreme Court has held that 20 minutes or so is a reasonable time frame for detaining someone. Reasonable suspicion means that there were objectively reasonable circumstances to suspect that the detained individual was involved in or was about to be involved in a crime. In typical detention scenario, law enforcement officers will typically stop a person in a public place without transporting the person to another location for the purpose of requiring the person to justify his presence and activity in the location and to identify himself. For example, if the police see a man loitering or otherwise acting suspicious around an area of town that is known for drug sales, they may detain him for further questioning. If while detaining him, the police have reasonable suspicion that he may be dangerous, the stop may be accompanied by a pat-down search for weapons.
That's a Terry pat.
That's right. This does not mean that the police can immediately reach into pockets or search a bag without permission. However, if the police feel a bulge that they believe could be a weapon, they may reach in to grab it in order to protect themselves. So they go on a little bit further. When detention leads to arrest an individual, and this is the important difference, law enforcement officers need probable cause to make an arrest. An arrest is characterized by the idea that a reasonable person would not feel free to leave due to the actions of the law enforcement officers. And this usually means the officers have taken...
So detention's reasonable, articulable suspicion, and arrest is probable cause.
That's correct. Custody can mean a couple of things. An individual may be taken into custody by driving them back to the police station. However, courts have also held custody to mean any situation in which an individual reasonably believes they will not be able to leave within a short period of time. So that's a little bit of info. I'll put the full link on our Facebook and Twitter for you to look further. So I've never heard the claim that there is no detention status, if you will, with the police. That's a first for me. And
it's
all the evidence I think suggests that there absolutely is a detained status. It's between arrest and free to go. So our toll-free number here, if you want to join us, is 855-450-FREE. A little bit more about the dog search ruling from the Federal Circuit of Court of Appeals, Seventh Circuit. The drug dog's alert in and of itself is often cited as evidence of drug activity, even if no drugs are found, thus enabling police to seize cash, cars, and other property from motorists. For example, Bradley Balco over at the Post writes, "I've interviewed dog trainers who have told me that drug dogs can be trained to alert only when there are measurable quantities of a drug, to ignore so-called trace or remnant alerts that aren't cause for arrest. But these trainers say that police agencies don't want dogs trained to ignore remnant odors because any alert is authorization for a more thorough search."
I remember back in the 80s, the claim used to be that every $100 bills would make a drug dog alert because of the cocaine.
Of cocaine.
Now, I don't know, this was pre-internet, and you should believe nothing that you heard prior to the internet, but and you have an opportunity to research it, and you should only believe half of the things you can research. But, trace amounts, there's a lot of things with trace amounts. If you're walking around in the wrong place, you're going to have stuff on your shoes.
In 2013, the Supreme Court made things worse in Florida versus Harris. In that case, the court unanimously ruled that a mere certification of a drug dog was enough to establish a presumption that the drug dog is reliable, regardless of the reputation of the certifying organization. I will tell you more coming up here in moments about the latest on the court's opinions about drug dogs. It's Free Talk Live.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Okay, honey, I have to ask, and be honest here. Have you been taking a little blue pill? Because things have been pretty good in the bedroom lately.
No, I swear.
You didn't pick anything up at the Pharmacia last month in Cancun?
No.
Well, something's different.
I have been taking that heart and body extract you bought me.
But that's for your heart and to control your cholesterol.
Well, I read HB extract also promotes healthy prostate function.
I never guessed it would work this well, but...
You're glad it did.
Oh, yeah.
Heart and Body Extract is a 100% organic formula that promotes a strong heart, healthy arterial flow,
better circulation, improves erectile and prostate gland function, and provides youthful energy, strength, and stamina. Find out more at heartandbodyextract.com. Heart and Body Extract, paired with healthy heart choices, is a winning combination. Call toll-free to order or for free information. 1-866-295-5305. 1-866-295-5305.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
Don't complain about your cable bill going up and up and up. Do something about it. Grab a pencil and jot down this special number. 1-855-905-MY-TV. The more cable TV rates go up, the better digital satellite TV looks. Say goodbye to the cable guy. And get more of your favorite channels in 100% digital quality for less money. Call 1-855-905-MY-TV. Sign up for packages starting as low as $19.99, and there's no equipment to buy. You get free HD TV upgrade, a free DVR upgrade, and free professional...
Me a supervisor
you
at
control
a dog
what you watch
just,
when you watch it. Record your favorite shows.
Huh?
Pause and rewind live TV. Even skip
it
the commercials. Watch local channels too. At just $19.99, what are you waiting for? Pull out your major credit or debit card. Call 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV. Say goodbye to the cable guy. Cut costs and get more. 1-855-905-MYTV. 1-855-905-MYTV.
Now, more Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Yeah! We're back. More Free Talk Live happening now. You can join us here toll-free. 855-450-FREE is our number. That's 855-450-3733. Also, join us via Skype if you prefer. I certainly prefer because you sound better. Skype username is lrn.fm, and that is wide open at the moment. So we've been talking about court rulings, specifically on the issue of drug dogs. I want to get back into your calls and thoughts on this here in a moment, but I also want to let you know about Purse, where... No lie, this is real. You can actually get 25% off of Amazon.
Can you imagine all the things that you use in life? And Amazon, you have just about everything you use in life. And obviously, you can't pay your mortgage and your power bill there.
Not
you
yet.
You probably can't get a fresh head of romaine lettuce there.
No, but I heard you can get steaks now.
You can get steaks, you can get lobster, you can get flounder. So you can, you know, get all the just about all the things you need in life, and you can get them at a 25% discount. Tell me that that's not just like getting a raise.
It's close.
Right.
Darn
you don't
close.
Have to agree with Free Talk Live's political opinions in order to benefit, to stretch your paycheck farther right now.
All you have to do is go to purse.freetalklive.com. You only have to go there to sign up. After you get signed up, you can go back through their normal URL, which is not purse.freetalklive.com. So just go to purse.freetalklive.com. The catch is you have to spend Bitcoin to get those huge discounts. And you can actually get 20, 25, maybe even more. I got these headphones for 29% off at Amazon. I just recently put something on there that I was looking for 25, I think it was 25% off some computer parts for the studio here. And the estimated time of delivery was like, or the estimated time for the order to be fulfilled, because you have to be a little patient, was like 48 hours. It was fulfilled within a few hours from when I placed it. So it's awesome. Go get started right now at purse.freetalklive.com.
And we'll tell you how to get some Bitcoins very easily and without much of a fee here real shortly.
Yeah. All right. So I want to get back into your calls, but a little more about what's going on in the courts with these drug dogs. It was in 2013, according to Radley Balco at the Washington Post, the Supreme Court made things worse with Florida versus Harris, where the court unanimously ruled that a mere certification of a drug dog was enough to establish that the drug dog is reliable, the presumption of that, regardless of the reputation of the certifying organization and regardless of whether that organization understands and appreciates the importance of training dogs to ignore their handler's suspicions, regardless of the dog's performance in the real world. The U.S. versus Bentley case that just went to the Seventh Circuit, we see just how damaging the Harris decision really was. Lex, the drug dog that searched Bentley's car, had a 93% alert rate. That is, when Lex was called to search a car, he alerted 93% of the time.
That's a lot of drugs Lex was finding.
He was basically a probable cause generator. His success rate, however, was much lower, at only 59%. And that is that the police actually found drugs in just about 6 out of the 10 times that Lex told them that they were going to find drugs.
You know what that tells me? Is it tells me that police officers in that case are pretty good at picking out who's going to have drugs and who isn't. Right? Like 6 out of 10 times... I mean, you know, it just goes to show that they're in the right neighborhood or they got the right, you know, prospecting tools. But Lex is a probable cause generating machine.
That means 4 out of every 10 people that Lex alerted to were subjected to a thorough roadside search that produced nothing illegal. But it gets worse. Even a dog that was well trained initially can be conditioned to pick up bad habits once it's out in the field. This is exactly what was happening with Lex. It turns out that Lex's handler gives the dog a reward every time he alerts, regardless of whether the alert was accurate.
Mm.
Lex isn't getting rewarded for filtering innocent motorists from guilty ones. He's being trained to authorize a search each and every time he's called to duty.
Sounds about right.
The Seventh Circuit found all of this troubling, even conceding that the reward policy was a, quote, terrible way to promote accurate detection, unquote. And yet, according to the 3-judge panel that heard the case, none of this was enough to amount to a violation of the Fourth Amendment, your supposed right to privacy. Following the Supreme Court's prescription in Harris...
Surprise, surprise, surprise! It sounds like the judicial is in collusion with the executive here.
Yeah.
I wonder if all 3 branches of the government work together to grow and become more powerful.
Following the Supreme Court's prescription in Harris, the opinion notes that the dog had passed tests in so-called controlled settings and cited testimony about the dog's reliability. But that testimony came from the dog's handler. And there's no further explanation of what those tests in the controlled settings meant. Were they conducted by the department? The handler? Did they include tests designed to fool the handler, as well as tests designed to fool the dog? The head of the agency that trained the dog also provided testimony about the quality of his group's training. But of course he'd say that. He also expressed concern about Lex's high alert rate and relatively low accuracy rate, and about the fact that Lex actually had failed 2 simulated vehicle searches. Yet the opinion points out that in the past, the Seventh Circuit found no problem with a drug dog whose accuracy rate was 62%. Lex's was only slightly lower. Moreover, the court notes that the U.S. Court of Appeals for the Fourth Circuit gave its okay to a dog with a success rate of 43%. That is less accurate than a coin flip.
Yeah.
This even lower number jibes with a 2011 Chicago Tribune investigation of suburban Chicago police dogs that found a success rate of just 44%. That review also found that with Latino drivers, the accuracy rate plunged to just 27%. More that of evidence that the dogs are merely reflecting the biases and presuppositions of their handlers. So that suggests that the officers believe that a Latino person is more likely to have drugs, and so therefore they bring the drug dog out. The dog alerts because that's what they're trained to do. But, oh look, only 27% of the searches in that case actually turned up drugs. So those officers weren't so good at detecting who has drugs. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Let's go to your calls and thoughts here. Joshua is listening in Albuquerque to Kiva. Hello, Joshua.
Hello, and thanks for having me on the show.
That's what we do. Go ahead. You're on the air.
Yes. Probable cause is a big problem over here. The DOJ, I don't know if you've heard of any news of that. But the DOJ has been investigating a lot of Albuquerque police, and
you mean like for the shootings where they shot that homeless man to death?
No, that was that's Albuquerque.
Yeah, that's Albuquerque. Yeah.
Exactly. It seems like they are taking over you know, overusing their power, and it's actually taking an effect on a lot of people here.
It absolutely is, and thank you, Joshua, for the call tonight. There's some
horrible
stories.
That's how power works, okay? I mean, you know, I'm sorry that that's the case, but that's how power works.
You mean it gets abused? Is that what you mean?
Every single time. There's evidence and, you know, what science they can do to look into this stuff that both the corrupt are attracted to power, and maybe the petty corrupt are attracted to petty power like police, and that the highly corrupt are attracted to high levels of power like the government, you know, like politicians and those sorts of things. But the corrupt are both attracted to power, and that power tends to corrupt the person that wields it, whether they were corrupt in the first place or not. This is kind of how it goes. And one of the problems, the integral central problems with power. Now, the people that have that power also they'll act like the underdog. They'll act like the vilified underclass. Whoa, nobody understands where we're coming from and why we have to do what we do. Western civilization would crumble without us.
855-450-FREE. That allows you to join us here. More of your calls coming up. Plus, we'll give you some audio from an actual pullover of some people that do know their rights. 855-450-FREE. Free Talk Live.
Affordable health insurance was the promise of Obamacare, but for many, the government mandate caused more problems than it solved. And I want to tell you about a truly affordable alternative, Liberty HealthShare. Liberty HealthShare bypasses doctor and hospital panels, giving you the freedom to choose. 100% coverage up to $1 million per year per occurrence includes dental, vision, pharmacy, and holistic care. Call 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993. 1-800-714-6993 today.
Anytime, any place, anywhere. Radio remains the most intimate of all forms of media. At home, at work, in the car, on smartphones. Over 90% of consumers still listen to radio every week. That makes choosing radio as a place to advertise your business one of the best decisions you can make. Email advertise@gcnlive.com and partner up with an experienced GCN representative. Advertise@gcnlive.com. Easy, affordable, effective.
Making the right decisions is a challenge to investors. Are we going to see economic growth, slide into a recession, or at worst, depression? Hi, Ted Anderson from Midas Resources. We all know when a company acts irresponsibly, divesting ourselves in a move towards safety is prudent. When the market becomes volatile, U.S. treasuries are a safe haven. But what do you do when the U.S. government overextends itself and spends beyond its means? Many investors are turning toward gold as a common-sense alternative to traditional paper investments. Midas Resources has put together a powerful book titled 10 Reasons to Own Gold, discussing costs, benefits, risks, featuring full-color illustrations, weights, and measures. The book is free and can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. Paper investments are dwarfed by gold's 6,000-year history. Discover how gold may be right for you and your IRA by calling 800-686-2237. Whether buying or it's time for you to sell, the book is free. Call 800-686-2237.
Buy now. You know that wireless technology like cell phones do in fact pose dangers to the health and privacy of everyone. Blockit Pocket's wide range of products are unmatched in providing the protection you deserve. No scare tactics, just common sense. BlockitPocket.com offers quality American-made options to alleviate and eliminate these invisible dangers. Learn more at BlockitPocket.com or call 888-315-9618. BlockitPocket.com, enhancing health and privacy.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson, Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas, is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. Even very smart, very accomplished people. It's part of being human. A quote taken out of context, a legal problem, an unfortunate photograph. Once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Because people love to dig up dirt, even when it's not real dirt. Put it to rest. Call for a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. Businesses, public figures, and professionals turn to Reputation.com for good reason. We protect your online image by helping make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Learn more about what the experts at Reputation.com can do for you. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Free Talk Live. Join us toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Live Saturday edition continuing. In studio, it's Ian.
And Mark.
And Mark, you said you'd tell us how to get Bitcoin. So how do you do that?
Right. And the reason that you want to get Bitcoin is because you can save up to 25% off of all of your purchases at Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. But the best way to get Bitcoin is to go through expresscoin.com. They've got Bitcoins, Litecoin, Dogecoin, but the Bitcoins are what we're talking about here with Purse. They make it fast, safe, easy, and inexpensive. They're a licensed money services business, so, no hanky-panky. I've done, a lot of business through them, and you have too, Ian, right?
Mm-hmm.
So get your cryptocurrencies with a money order or check, whether you're in the U.S. or Canada, through expresscoin.com. They've got an app to make it easy for you if you want to use an app on your smartphone. Use coupon code FTL, that's FTL as in Free Talk Live, to get up to $40 worth of your cryptocurrency with no fee at all. It's expresscoin.com, coupon code FTL.
All right, let's go right into your calls and thoughts. We got Will. He's in Norfolk. Will, you're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark.
Hey, how you doing, guys?
Welcome, sir.
Let me just make a shout-out to Joshua there in Albuquerque. I'm from Santa Fe, New Mexico, so that's kind of cool.
Everybody's from somewhere, but, buddy.
All right, what were you calling about?
Wanted to talk about I got two comments on number one on the search and seizure with the drug dogs. So I believe one of the things that cops are able to use as far as probable cause is line of sight, like it was in plain sight kind of thing. Well, if a drug dog is an extension of an officer, well, their sight is really good, but their smell is also really, really good.
Mm-hmm.
And so if that dog is the extension of an officer, does that also become like it was in plain sight? The dog smelled it?
I think that's
legit.
And
I understand about the training and the, blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, but I think that would be the argument that the justice or the police would make if you did try to challenge a search based on what the former officer had suggested earlier, which was that that the dog is an officer, and if you've refused a search, then therefore the dog cannot do a search. But the viewpoint of the police would be that, well, the dog wasn't searching. It was simply observing, or in this case, using its nose to sort of observe the environment.
Sure, and so that would be a plain sight argument, correct?
Probably.
Yeah, I think that's right.
Okay.
And once the dog comes out, things are getting very, very complicated.
Yeah, and I want to kind of make it clear. I'm calling. I'm a convicted felon. I've had drug offenses. I did 16 months in the Texas Department of Corrections. But I'm also a realist as well. And you had a guy that called from here a few calls back. From Newport News, which is actually where I'm calling from, just literally like a stone's throw away.
Mm-hmm.
And he was talking about the, people talking about cops pulling people over, pulling people aside, and they don't know their rights. And it's like, if they got arrested and they got busted, and I'm sorry, I'm not a big guy about this victim circumstances. Like, if you don't know your rights, then it's like, welcome to the game, sucker. Mm-hmm.
So you don't feel sorry for people who don't know their rights?
Not really, because it's all right there.
Well,
thanks for the call, Will. I appreciate hearing from you.
I disagree because people start off in the system very young. Many people begin with their arrests at 15, 16, 17. Mm-hmm. They're not teaching you that in public school, right?
I mean, they don't want you to know your rights.
You know, the best thing you can teach a kid is never, ever, ever speak to the police without your attorney present. But I mean, you know, you also teach them to obey authority figures. You send them to school with an authority figure. You act like authority figure at home. Almost all the adults in their lives, you know, the coach at the baseball team and the Cub Scouts and whatever, authority figure, authority figure, authority figure. And then when they come in contact with an authority figure, you don't want them to talk to the authority figure because they might or say anything incriminating. I mean, it's a ridiculous notion. Yes, there are, you know, games, and yes, you can learn them by going through the system, but this guy's a convicted felon, like I am, and I don't want people to learn the game this way. I think the game would be best played if we eliminate the war on drugs. The Constitution has been eviscerated by the war on drugs. Police no longer serve us because of the war on drugs. And that, you know, whatever the consequences are of doing drugs, as far as I can tell, the consequences of the war on drugs was the Republic.
Well, yeah. Well, that guy, you know, seemed kind of jaded. And I can understand being jaded after, you know, doing time for a felony. I can get that. But I feel like, you know, if you can't find empathy for a person who doesn't know their rights, at the very least, try to find some sympathy for that poor person because they're getting screwed. And any one of us, and here's why you should be able to empathize instead of sympathize. To empathize, you know, means being able to put yourself in that person's shoes. This can happen to anybody, and I don't care how respectable you are, how nice of a car you drive, it can still happen to you. It's not as likely to happen to you, but it certainly can still occur where the police will run roughshod all over your rights, and then you'll be wondering how that could have possibly happened. Well, it's because you stood by and you didn't do anything when other people were having their rights violated, which is, of course, one of the things that the folks over at copblock.org do very, very well, which is they go out, they hit the streets, they have video cameras, and they show up at places where the police are. A lot of pullovers, roadside situations where the cop block folks will show up and record video of that situation. And further, sometimes they will insert themselves into the situation, not in a way that will obstruct the police from doing their investigation, but in a way that will help the victim, the person who's being pulled over by the police in that case, know their rights. So, for instance, I've actually gone up to, and the average, you know, the newbies to cop block aren't going to do this. And in some areas of the country, I wouldn't recommend you try it. But around here, it works fine. When the police walk away from the window, you know, they approach, get your driver's license or whatever, and they walk back to their car. Once they've walked back to the car, I will sometimes ask the person, you know, first of all, before I'm recording them, if I'm recording, I will ask, do you want me to keep an eye on this? Do you want me to record this? And then I'll also, if I have a cop block Know Your Rights card on me, I will offer them that information. So it's not too late for them to actually read a thing or two about their rights actually during the stop. Now, of course, that's really the last time you want to be given that sort of information, which is why we'll also hit up the college neighborhood and flyer hundreds of flyers every single year informing people of their rights, because you could be that person. Even if you do know your rights, at some point you probably didn't know your rights. So try to empathize with the people who don't know them and do something to help those folks. They could be you. That could be your brother or your sister or your lover who is being taken advantage of by the police.
And you can be certain that your attorney, when you have to deal with these situations, he's going to want you to have shut your mouth. That's what he's going to want you to have done.
Yeah, for sure.
Actually, you may not have to hire the attorney if you keep your mouth shut. So your attorney may not want you to keep your mouth shut, but that's his advice.
Well,
his
advice
is to never talk to the police. Go on YouTube and search talk to the police and see what comes up.
It's generally a bad idea to talk to the police, but nowadays there is a Supreme Court decision, as I understand it, that says you essentially do have to assert your right to remain silent.
Yes.
So at the very minimum, you will have to say something like, I'm using my right to remain silent, but shouldn't say much more than
that. Am I free to go?
Yeah, that's another one.
Am I being detained?
If you're going to say anything, am I free to go is a good one. Mark is in Wilmington, Delaware. You're on Free Talk Live. Hello, Mark.
Hi, thanks for taking my call.
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
I got arrested when I was 17 years old because I thought I knew my rights, but I didn't know the law. I was arrested for disorderly conduct by an off-duty state police officer. He assaulted my friend. My friend knocked him down. And I stood over him and I told him, don't get up. Well, he got up and he pulled out his badge. And he said, I'm the captain, state police. I want to see ID. And I was like, I'm an innocent bystander here. I don't need to show you anything. Well, that was my mistake, because in the state of Delaware, when a police officer identifies himself and asks for ID, you have to give it. So when you get pulled over and people are thinking, well, because a lot of people, they don't know what to do. And of course, the first thing the police officer asks is registration, ID.
Stand by, Mark. We'll come back here in moments with more. It's Free Talk Live.
Attention, business owners. Do you know the three most critical letters in business?
CEO? MBA?
Nope. Here's a hint. These three little letters can make the difference between making a fortune and losing everything.
ROI?
The answer is INC, as in incorporation. Because if you're not incorporated and someone sues your business, you can lose it all. Your home, your car, even your life savings. That's why Incorporate.com is now giving away a free incorporation guide to all business owners, so you can incorporate in just 10 minutes. Protect your home. Protect your car. Protect your life savings. Call 1-800-941-1029 for your free 10-minute incorporation guide from Incorporate.com. They don't provide legal or financial advice. They just make incorporating or forming an LLC quick and easy. Get the three little letters that can mean the difference between making a fortune and losing everything. For your free guide, call 1-800-941-1029. That's 1-800-941-1029.
The human body is more than 60% water. Your brain and muscles are 75% water. And your blood is 92% water. Water is vital to your body, and alkalizing your water is the key to keep it running at its best. AlkaVision Plasma pH drops keep your entire body healthy, boosts energy, promotes weight loss, and even fights cancer. Call 800-518-7615 or go to AlkaVision.com to find out more. That's ALKAVision.com.
We are a survival company. We manufacture our own line of Level 3 and Level 3A body armor. We proudly make our armor 100% in America. We have the best prices in the nation, about $125 cheaper than our nearest competitor. All lab certified, for thou art my rock and my fortress, Psalm 31:3. We are Fortress Survival LLC.com.
For over 5 years, you've been hearing about the Berkey guy, so you may know a few things about him. For example, you are well aware of the superior quality and effectiveness of Berkey water filters and accessories. But did you know the Berkeys have had independent lab tests done to prove just how effective they are? It's true, and he can email you the test results. Just visit GoBerkey.com. You may also know that the Berkey guy has helped tens of thousands of people get better prepared. Now here's something you may not know. GoBerkey.com has amazing specials and deals all the time on a wide variety of survival and preparedness products, most ready to ship same day. Visit the Berkey guy at GoBerkey.com and be sure to click the red Products on Sale Now button. You can always call toll-free 877-886-3653. Again, that's 877-886-3653. GoBerkey.com, home of the Berkey guy.
Have you ever felt like the United States government knows way too much about your financial affairs? I continue to hear stories about property seizures, frozen bank accounts, confiscation of stocks and bonds. It makes me wonder if the U.S. citizen will ever again have the right to life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Unfortunately, with the Drug and Money Laundering Act, the IRS Revenue Ruling 6045 of 1984, and the Trading with the Enemy Act and Franklin D. Roosevelt's Executive Order of 1933, some precious metal holdings are subject to government intervention. For this reason, Midas Resources has prepared a report explaining the boundaries of trading precious metals privately. Whether if you have any intention of trading with Midas Resources or not, I have instructed my representatives to give this report out free. Call for your free copy at 1-800-686-2237. When investing, always proceed with caution. Again, call 1-800-686-2237. Exercise your legal right to trade metals privately. 1-800-686-2237.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll-free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
We're back. It's Free Talk Live. Of course, you can bring up anything you want, though the focus tonight has certainly been on the police, specifically your interactions with them on the side of the road with drug dogs, because there's a not a Supreme Court case yet, but a federal appeals court, the Seventh Circuit, has decided in the favor of drug dogs, even though a lot of information studies are showing they're not particularly reliable. In fact, some of them are less reliable than a coin flip. As far as
that is disturbing,
they're alerting on your car, and then whether or not they actually find drugs in the car, some of these dogs less often than a coin flip is how reliable they are. So there's more to say about that. Also, I've got audio from the side of the road in Austin with a couple of activists who do know their rights. We were talking about how police will take advantage of you if you don't know your rights, and learning your rights isn't a, you know, you don't have to go to a college class to learn your rights. There's some great online tools, Flex Your Rights is a great organization that has come up with a couple of videos that you can go and you can watch for free online that'll talk to you about, you know, your rights on the side of the road, your rights in your home, because it changes. Your ability to
different places it changes.
Yeah, your ability to flex your rights does make a difference based on where you are. And we were talking with Mark in Wilmington about his experience where a friend, I guess, got into some sort of a scuffle with an off-duty police officer. Mark, you were there observing, and then the officer identified himself as an officer and demanded identification. You, not realizing there was a apparently an obligation in Delaware law to identify yourself, did not do so and were charged with disorderly conduct. Is that pretty much a recap of what you've told us so far?
Correct. Then they towed my car. I wasn't even in my car. We were out of my car. I was taken back to the police station, and I was beaten.
Whoa.
By the police. Now, I'm 17 years old.
How many cops were beating you?
Just one.
Mm-hmm. Did the other police know that that was happening?
Well, the officer who arrested me was a captain of state police.
Right.
And all he did was, when he jumped up and he identified himself, I'm like, I don't care who you are. You just assaulted my friend and you're asking me for ID. And I pushed him back because I thought that I had the right not to identify myself.
You physically pushed him, or?
No, I mean, verbally, I pushed him back.
Okay, yeah.
You know, because I just thought that he's in the wrong, I'm in the right. Anyway, they arrest me for disorderly conduct, which was his mistake because the judge threw the case out.
Really? Why?
Because I should have been arrested for failure to comply.
Hmm.
Because he asked me for identification, and there were other people there. I had like three witnesses who saw this guy act like a maniac. But anyway,
I think this is mostly a contempt of cop case, and that's, you know, the cop's pretty happy that he got the beating in and those sorts of situations.
Did anything happen as far as holding him accountable for beating you?
No.
Wow.
No, there's no proof for these kind of things.
What happened was I was in a room with him. A police officer walked in. He didn't say anything except he nodded to the guy. And I was handcuffed to a door.
Ugh.
And the guy came in, he punched me twice and left.
The captain came in or the other officer?
No, the other guy.
I was in the room with the captain.
So he had one of his flunkies come in and do his business for him.
Exactly.
Mark, thanks for calling with your story tonight. I'm sorry to hear it,
I only want to say one thing, because this is the problem that I had, is that when an officer identifies himself and asks you for ID, that's what you have to do, because the judge dismissed the case, but he told me after we talked, he's like, ignorance of the law is not an excuse.
You know, I love that 12th century maxim from back when the law really had to do with harming other people, because ignorance of the law isn't an excuse. It is the state of every man, woman, and child in and around the world. No one can possibly know all the laws that are written down for any given geographical area. That judge doesn't know them. That officer doesn't know them, and there's no way you could know them.
But it's still useful, Mark, to call in and tell us about that one. Thank you for the call tonight. I appreciate it. We have discussed, and by the way, this particular law varies Okay, so your mileage may vary where you are located. There's differing versions of this. I don't think every state has that requirement. And again, this isn't legal advice. I'm not an attorney. I'm just, you know, a liberty activist who cares about these sorts of things. But it is my understanding that you cannot be obligated to have a government ID on you, but when you are asked to identify yourself, you can simply identify yourself. Okay,
that's my understanding too.
So in a situation like Mark was in, where, you know, let's say he doesn't, you know, you're just walking to the store or whatever. You weren't driving somewhere, so you've right. no reason to have, or you're the passenger.
You don't have
in the
to
car.
Have ID to identify yourself.
Right. You can just simply tell him, I'm so and so, and I think you in some places have to give your birth date, right? So name and birth date, and that generally is what will identify you. It allows them to go and look you up in their system and check for warrants and things like that.
Best not to lie in those circumstances either, in my opinion. Yeah. I have heard it work out for people, but I wouldn't give the advice to do that.
No, I would not either, and we're not giving advice. These are just suggestions.
My advice is to tell the truth, generally, and my advice is don't speak to the police unless you absolutely, or prosecutors, or anybody, without your attorney present.
Mark is not an attorney. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. Let's go to John. He's in Jackson, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live on the Live Saturday Show. Hello, John.
Hey, how you doing?
Welcome, sir. Go ahead.
I'm actually in Mississippi.
Oh, my bad. All right, go ahead.
Well, I've been arrested several times down here over the years, and never once have they read me my Miranda rights. Now,
they are not obligated to.
That's TV.
Right, so when they read you your rights is only before they're going to question you. So it's very common for people to watch this on television and presume that they have to read them immediately upon putting the handcuffs on you. That is just for dramatic purposes on television and movies.
Ah.
So, and again, this isn't legal advice, but that's just, you know, my understanding is that if they're going to question you, which means that they can wait until they get you back to the station, and then, you know, they've got you in your cell or in the holding room or whatever, and then an officer comes in there, he wants to start asking you questions, it's at that point that you need to be informed of your so-called Miranda rights. So hopefully that clears that up, John, and thanks for the call tonight, man. Let's continue with Jeremiah listening in Alpena, Michigan. You're on Free Talk Live. Jeremiah.
Hi, I just wanted to make 2 points. One was a gentleman earlier that said you need to know your rights, and if not, welcome to the game. We signed a contract amongst ourselves civilly, in a civilian-type status with our Constitution and everything else surrendering specific rights. And the responsibility of authority is to respect those rights and inform us. It shouldn't be, we cannot keep up, like you guys were just saying, with all the laws that were passed. That's just the point I wanted to make. And then,
well, I question that. I didn't sign the Constitution, and you didn't sign the Constitution. The Constitution was signed by a bunch of dead people, and frankly, if it was intended to bind any people to some kind of set of rules, those rules have been broken a long time ago, and when they were broken, there was no penalty. So the Constitution, if it has any authority, is, you know, it's certainly not being enforced.
Well, I agree with you there. I agree with you. That's the pretense, I should say.
It is the pretense, yes.
True. My bad. Literally, I have earned my degree in criminal justice, but I walked away from the field because, and I think this is where a head point of the corruption is happening, and we haven't really seen it so much or where it's manifesting so much now. What I've been taught in my classes, we were instructed as students that if we suspect that we are going to get a conviction from anybody we pull over, any interface we have with any civilian, that we should feel free to violate their rights in any means necessary if we can feel we can get a conviction, because it will be looked over within the courts if we can find drugs or find some other situation that we're going to convict them of a crime.
Well, and it'll certainly be looked over in the courts if it never makes it to court, which most cases don't, because most people take a plea deal. That's a disturbing story, and it's believable. Thanks for the call, Jeremiah. I appreciate it. I'm glad you didn't go into that line of work. The toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733.
The problem is that I want people like Jeremiah in that line of work. The sad thing is that it ends up being that guys like Jeremiah are driven out. The people who are, well, okay, violate rights, fine. Mm. Those are the ones that can stick around. And I think that departments have, I don't know, maybe it's my naivety to believe that they at one point were better, Maybe not. I don't know what the answer is. I guess the answer is that some departments were better and some departments are worse, and some departments now are better and some departments are now are worse. But the fact is that the war on drugs has eviscerated the Bill of Rights, and that's not going to change, and police aren't going to protect us from that, sadly.
All right, we got time for you if you want to join us here. Our toll-free number is 855-450-FREE. Also, Skype in at Skype username lrn.fm. You just need to send a quick contact request first. Once we approve it, you're good to go from that point forward. We got more coming up. Hour number three is next. We've got more of the live Saturday edition of Free Talk Live. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. More coming up in moments.
Shaquille O'Neal for Icy Hot.
If you've got pain, you need the patch.
The Icy Hot Patch. Powerful, targeted, fast-acting pain relief that stays put without the mess. Icy to dull the pain, hot to relax it away. In a variety of sizes, from back, shoulders, knees, even arthritis. So you're covered whenever and wherever you hurt. Stop pain right at the source with Icy Hot Patches.
Pain's no match for the Icy Hot Patch.
For temporary topical pain relief, use only as directed.
Every summer we go to Canyon Woods. Love getting outside. Love the hiking. Hate the itching and irritation from poison ivy, bug bites, all the things that keep me inside. So I need something strong.
Cortisone 10 Intensive Healing is clinically proven with the strongest non-prescription itch medicine available for fast, long-lasting relief of itching and irritation with 7 moisturizers to help heal skin.
I finally have the relief I need.
Hey, Jan, check this out.
On my way.
Cortisone 10. Feel the heal.
Did you know some countries are now banning GMO foods? It's true. That's why for quality storable foods, you need ready-made resources. For over 19 years, we've become the name you can trust for thousands of products, like Numana Healthy Food Storage. All Numana storable foods are non-GMO, non-soy, and gluten-free available. Call 800-627-3809 or click readymaderesources.com. Ready-made resources. We don't just sell the products, we live it.
If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Call to Decision with Pastor Butch Baugh, GCN.
With SRN News, I'm Ron DeRockstra. A plume of yellow sludge that's polluted a river in southwestern Colorado now reaching into northern New Mexico. About 1 million gallons of wastewater from Colorado's Gold King mine began spilling into the river on Wednesday. EPA Region 8 Administrator Sean McGrath says the waste leak's causing problems that's going to take a while to fix.
This is going to be a long-term impact. The sediment, the metals that are in that sediment are going to settle out to the stream bottom.
Meanwhile, David Ostrander, the director of EPA Emergency Response and Preparedness Program for Region 8, says the water's been cut off to some towns.
There is one primary intake for the city of Durango. That water intake is turned off. There is also on the Southern Ute Tribe, there is a water diversion to a water supply reservoir. That has been turned off.
Officials in Aztec and Farmington, New Mexico have shut down the river's access to water treatment plants there. They say the communities have about a 90-day supply. Also at SRNnews.com, at Red State 2015 in Atlanta today, GOP hopefuls had a second chance at a first impression following Thursday night's debate. Former Arkansas Governor Mike Huckabee says he'll stand up for religious freedoms.
The assaults on our religious liberty are serious, and they cannot go unchallenged. And the notion that the Supreme Court can redefine marriage after 6,000 years of human history is on its face absurd.
While former Florida Governor Jeb Bush told the crowd if he's elected president, he would make sure the American dream comes alive again.
5 million more people are in poverty today than the day that Barack Obama got elected president of the United States. And the middle of this country, the great middle that defines us, hadn't gotten a raise in a long, long while. It seems to me this election needs to be about how do we rise up again.
National Park Service says a Montana man found dead in Yellowstone National Park Friday was the victim of a grizzly bear attack. This is SRN News.
2 little tablets is all it takes to get thicker, fuller hair guaranteed. Viviscal is the number one drug-free hair growth supplement in the U.S., with one box being sold every minute globally. It's clinically proven, loved by celebrities, and recommended by doctors. And right now, a 90-day supply of Viviscal is being offered in your area risk-free, plus free shipping. Call 800-481-7987. Viviscal nourishes thinning hair from within. It makes thin hair full, full hair beautiful, and promotes the growth of thicker, fuller hair guaranteed. Viviscal is so effective, 96% of women would recommend it to a friend. Listen to this.
It's vibrant, shiny, bouncy, everything you want your hair to be. I love Viviscal because it works. It completely works.
Want to try Viviscal? Every listener that calls can try it risk-free for 90 days, plus free shipping. Get thicker, fuller hair guaranteed. Call now, 800-481-7987. 800-481-7987. That's 800-481-7987.
Teen employment, it's one of the bright spots in the July jobs report.
The unemployment rate for those 16 to 19 fell almost 2 percentage points from June to 16.2%. That's the lowest level since March of 2008. Since the Great Recession, teens have had an especially tough time finding jobs. Their unemployment rate has hovered above 20% for much of the past 7 years.
SRN's Rich Thomason says Black Americans also made progress in July. Their jobless rate fell for a second straight month to 9.1%. A typhoon's pounding southeast China, leaving more than a million homes without power after it lashed Taiwan, where it downed trees, traffic lights, and power lines and left 6 people dead and 4 missing. The typhoon hit the Fujian province late Saturday night and is expected to move across the region. This is SRN News. A new government report finds only a handful of railroads are even close to meeting a December 31st deadline to install certain safety equipment. More from SRN's Linda Kenyon.
The equipment known as Positive Train Control, or PTC, can prevent many crashes, including derailments like the deadly Amtrak crash in Philadelphia in May. A report by the National Transportation Safety Board says only 3 railroads have submitted safety plans to the government. That's an important step before PTC can be put into operation. The railroads are BNSF Railway, the nation's second largest freight railroad, and 2 commuter railroads, Metrolink in Los Angeles and the Southeastern Pennsylvania Transportation Authority. Linda Kenyon, SRN News, Washington.
It's the anniversary of the start of the U.S. airstrikes against the Islamic State group in Iraq. A U.S.-led coalition has conducted nearly 6,000 airstrikes against extremists, expanding into Syria as well. More details at srnnews.com. I'm Ron DeRockstra.
Virtually anyone can hack your cell phone and track your calls, your texts, your emails, your every movement, but only if they can detect a signal. Stay one step ahead of hackers and Big Brother with a Blockit Pocket, a custom-made pocket infused with pure silver that creates a complete Faraday enclosure for your cell phone. For free shipping to the Lower 48, visit blockitpocket.com or call 888-315-9618. blockitpocket.com. Enhancing health and privacy.
Want to listen to your favorite GCN hosts and programs without a radio signal or internet? Just call 605-562-4213. Get instant access to all GCN live feeds right on your phone, anywhere you want, anytime you want. 605-562-4213. It's our way of ensuring everyone has the opportunity to enjoy GCN. 605-562-4213. The future of talk radio. GCN.
It is Free Talk Live, and you're welcome to join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Joining you in the studio tonight, you've got Ian.
And King Mark.
And we have been discussing the issue of drug dogs, and specifically a new court decision that is yet again upholding the idea of a drug dog, even though there's all kinds of evidence that suggests that they are easily corruptible, meaning that... Not that the dogs are bad dogs, but that they are you know, they're interested in pleasing their master, and their master, of course, is the man who is training them and is utilizing them at a police stop.
What drug dogs are good for is figuring out what the police officer that's handling them wants.
Right, and that officer wants to search, so the dogs are more likely than not to find drugs in that vehicle, even though the officers don't always find the drugs. In fact, in some cases, they're less than half as likely to find the drugs, meaning that coin toss would be more likely to find those drugs than a drug dog search. So we can talk more about that. That has sort of led into a larger discussion about your rights with the police and how to express to those police that you know your rights and that you're exercising your rights in as legal a manner as possible without giving legal advice, because we're not attorneys. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. You can join us on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm. Let's go right back to the phones and the fun. James is in Des Moines. You're on Free Talk Live with Ian and Mark. Go ahead, James. James in Des Moines.
Yeah, I've been a law enforcement for a long, long time, about 35 years, and there are far more good cops out there than the bad ones. And I personally, and I don't know any guys that I've ever worked with that have stepped on someone's rights or railroaded someone into doing something that they didn't do, where they weren't guilty of, and the drug dogs, they're worth their weight in gold, in my opinion. Just because they don't find, if they indicate on the car and they don't find drugs in the car, doesn't mean there weren't drugs in that car at one time and there's trace evidence in there that the drug that the dog hit on, the odor in the carpeting or in the seats or whatever.
That's a but convenient these
are,
excuse.
These are tests, not done on...
Better than a coin flip.
Well, these are tests done by independents that are saying that when they take items that didn't have drugs in them and that sort of thing, and then lead the officer to believe that there are drugs in there and get the dog to alert, that these are tests done by an independent organization, and this isn't
where they're not using a car necessarily or
right.
whatever.
And I don't disagree with you that there are better departments and worse departments, and that that the police tend to be a reflection of their department. I'm not going to disagree with that for a second, but I mean, they took drug dogs and they compared them to mind-sniffing dogs, and drug dogs came up short not because of the dog, but because of their handlers.
Yeah. Well, I'm not a canine handler. I just know the guys that we use in our area, and they are really good at what they do. The dogs are outstanding. I'm not saying, there are some drug dogs.
I mean, if you think it's a good thing to violate people's rights, then I guess I could understand where you're coming from. But if you think it's a good thing to put peaceful people in prison cells who've never harmed anybody else, then I guess I see where you're coming from.
You did not say that. If you want to put that poison in your body, go ahead. Knock yourself out. I have no problem with that, as long as it affects you and you only.
Oh, yeah. Great.
Don't bring it out here where it affects me and my family and everybody else, the other public that don't want nothing to do with that.
Well, it doesn't affect you if it's in my car, right?
Like, finish this table.
Draw the line there.
If it's in my car, it doesn't affect you.
But in your car, you bring it out here on the highway. It's in the car.
It's just sitting in the car. It's not affecting you.
What's that?
The drug's just sitting in the glove compartment.
It has to get home somehow.
I'm not saying I have drugs in my car. I'm just saying, in theory, if I did, the drugs are in the car. That doesn't mean I'm high on them at the moment.
Exactly. Well, that's very true.
Yeah.
Can't argue that.
So you're fine. So that's good to know. So you support...
I don't condone it. It's illegal.
Right. You support an individual's right to own their own body and put whatever they want in it, though.
Yeah. If it doesn't affect anybody else...
Cool.
But it's illegal. I have to enforce the laws.
Well, no, you don't. You have discretion.
Well, if I stop somebody, if I find a kilo of cocaine in the car, I'm not going to let them go down the road.
Why?
I'm not going to sell it to some 5-year-old.
What's wrong with a kilo of cocaine? What's wrong with that?
It's illegal to possess it.
That's not what's wrong with it, sir. No. To answer that it's illegal to possess it does not responsively answer the question, what's wrong with it? There's nothing wrong with it,
illegal, right?
Nothing
wrong with it as far as the pot yourself.
Thanks for the call tonight.
Ian, there's no country on the planet.
I appreciate it, James. Thank you.
Country on the planet where you're going to be able to drive around with a kilo of cocaine in your car. I'm not saying that that's a good thing. I believe people should only use cocaine for medicinal purposes. I don't think it has any particular recreational value compared to other recreational drugs out there.
I'm sure cocaine users would disagree with you.
I'm sure they would, and I think
they stay up all night on that stuff.
I think that their lives are a testament to that. Mm. However, I think that they'd be worse off being thrown in jail cells. But somebody has to deliver the cocaine to those people. Look, I that sounded like an officer that got it, and he sounded like he was at a pretty good department. I don't think it's worth lambasting people. You did manage to ferret out that this guy, he's actually pretty libertarian in his thought process. But
I don't know about that, Mark.
He said he didn't care whether you did it.
I'll give him that, yeah, but I wouldn't necessarily say that his thought process is pretty libertarian. He was also praising drug dogs as though they were doing a great job, and he wants to put a guy in jail who's got a kilo of cocaine who hasn't hurt anybody.
He thinks that the ones in his department are better than others. What a surprise. I mean, I think our radio show is better than others for whatever reason. People tend to be biased towards their organizations.
Well, my dog is actually better than your
dog. See, there you go. Yeah. You believe that your dog is better than my dog and everybody else's dog.
And by any metric, my dog's better than your dog.
I agree with you. Exactly. You have a fine right. animal.
Toll-free number tonight, 855.
Let's see what kind of gun dog she is, though. Has she ever been around a shotgun?
No, I don't think she'd like
that. No, I mean, maybe she's not such a great hunting dog.
I didn't say she was a good hunting dog.
You said she was a great dog compared to every other dog. It's the metrics that you care about that matter, Mr. Bias.
855-450-FREE. Yeah, and as far as metrics go, I don't care if it's a metric ton or a metric ounce of... wait, can you have a metric ounce?
No.
No.
You don't care if it's a milligram or a metric ton.
I don't
milligram
care.
Milligram or
whatever.
A kilogram. That would be better. It's more alliterative.
There you go. Yeah, see, to me, it doesn't matter. There's no victim if you're carrying cocaine around. Not at all. And there's no victim anytime someone is buying or selling drugs. So leave those guys alone. 855-450-FREE. Let's continue. Quentin is on the line, listening to WIBC. Quentin.
Yes.
Welcome, sir. You're on the air.
Okay. My question for you, and I guess it's not really a question so much as it's, I guess, a statement. We have in this country so many groups that defend the Second Amendment. We have open carry groups. We have the NRA. We have the guys from South Park defending the First Amendment. Why don't we have groups standing up for the Fourth Amendment? Because without the Fourth Amendment, the First and Second don't exist. You can't have a printing press. You can't have a gun if they come into your house and take them. Why can't we, as a society, look at the Fourth Amendment and say, well, this is where it all begins. This is where it all stops.
So the good news is
they can't take things from us.
Well, they do.
That's really what it comes. Well, I mean, they do. Obviously, they do.
Quentin, just to fill you in a little bit here. I don't know if you were tuned in earlier when I was talking about Flex Your Rights. This is a great organization that has made some very interesting and entertaining videos. There are at least two of them that I know about.
Sure, and I'm aware of that.
Okay.
But what I'm saying to you is why it's not more.
It's not bigger.
Why it's not bigger? Why it's not out in the forefront? Because I mean, you turn on CNN and you see things about open carry.
Yeah.
You see things about the NRA, and they talk about the First Amendment, but nobody seems to want to talk about the Fourth Amendment.
I think it's an excellent point. It certainly does not get as much attention as the rights in the previous amendments. And thank you, Quentin, for the call tonight. Although I'd also suggest maybe the ACLU is also defending that particular right. Thank you for the call tonight. So there are
some vilified.
Groups. There are some groups out there. 855-450-FREE, 855-450-3733. More coming up on Free Talk Live.
This is a life-changing message for anyone with sleep apnea who is on the go and tired of dragging around a big, bulky home CPAP device. MiniCPAP.com now offers a portable device that's as small as a soda can and weighs less than a pound. For even more freedom, you can add a battery that's as tiny as a deck of cards. It's called the Transcend Mini CPAP, and right now you can try it risk-free for 21 days by calling 1-800-939-8536. Transcend is the world's first portable mini CPAP device. It gives you the freedom to sleep in total comfort anywhere you are. Our smallest and most advanced portable design ever, Transcend, is so small and so light you can fit it in your briefcase or purse to use anywhere you go. It's FAA compliant too, so you can even sleep comfortably while flying. Enjoy the freedom to sleep comfortably anywhere. Call MiniCPAP.com now for your 21-day in-home trial. 1-800-939-8536. That's 1-800-939-8536.
In the U.S. alone, a home invasion occurs every 13 seconds. On top of that, the average response time for 911 is over 15 minutes. That just won't cut it. Don't allow yourself or the important people in your life to be victims. When seconds matter, don't be caught stumbling for your firearm. Get the protection you deserve. Get yourself a hidden holster from HiddenHolster.com. It's the original hidden holster. The hidden holster is quick, easy, and convenient. It's versatile enough for the home, workplace, or virtually anywhere else you might need it. Have peace of mind with your firearm close by at all times. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. If you own a firearm, you need a hidden holster. Your protection matters, and self-defense is the best defense. Go to HiddenHolster.com. That's HiddenHolster.com. The original hidden holster.
Are you tired of commuting to a job that makes someone else rich? Working harder than ever, but getting nowhere? Do you hate spending hundreds of dollars every week on daycare? Having someone else raise your children? With our opportunities, you can start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss, work from home, and live a happier life. At Be the Boss Network, you'll find hundreds of work-from-home opportunities that you can literally start today and be earning money as soon as next week. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You get to be the boss. Get out of the rat race. Work from home. Go to freedom106.com right now and change your life today. That's freedom, the number 106.com. Go to freedom106.com and start earning money as soon as next week. You be the boss. Go to freedom106.com.
If you're worried about your health and you're tired of the nasty side effects of harsh drugs or antibiotics, then look no further. Supernatural Silver is the answer. Supernatural Silver is a powerful immune system enhancer that can be used every day to help keep you healthy and well with none of those nasty side effects. It's extremely safe for use internally as well as topically. And Supernatural Silver is hundreds of times more effective than colloidal or ionic silver. It is perfect for use in the sinuses, eyes, ears, and on any wound or skin issue. Supernatural Silver is also extremely effective when taken orally and can help fight off bacteria, viruses, and mold that may be overwhelming your immune system. Go to SupernaturalSilver.com, SupernaturalSilver.com, and use the promo code SILVER2015 for 30% off of your entire order, and give yourself and your loved ones a fighting chance with Supernatural Silver.
Now more Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
Hey, it's Free Talk Live, the live Saturday edition continuing now. I'm Ian.
And I'm Mark.
And you can reach us here toll-free. If you want to join us, 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Let's say you do get pulled over by the police. Well, if you got cell 411 on your smartphone, you can punch it up and hit a button, basically, to send out an alert to your friends and your family members who also have cell 411. They will be alerted to your status, your situation, and they'll be given the opportunity to respond by letting you know, hey, I'm on my way, and it'll tell you how far away they are if you are still looking at your phone at that point. Hopefully you are at that point also pulling up your Bambuser app, which is a great app that actually allows you to record video of the circumstance. But before you start that video, you can send out your cell 411 request and have people actually show up To respond, at least if you've got an activist network like we have here in New Hampshire. Cell 411 is also good for people that are doing neighborhood watch. Maybe you've got an elderly relative who might need some medical assistance. It'll send out medical alerts, alerts about the police. It'll send out, I think, fire as well. I don't have it pulled up at the moment.
Imagine if you could just send out an alert and all your surrounding neighbors would know that you have an emergency at the house that they could respond to. That'd be awesome. I can tell you in my neighborhood, that would be invaluable.
Yeah, this could be a lifesaver. Go to get your copy of Cell 411. I think it's all of 99 cents, and it may still be free in the Apple Store. Go check it out. Look for Cell, C-E-L-L, 411. It is perfect for you if you're an activist or a neighborhood watcher, medical worker, or just a concerned family member. Cell 411. As we go right back into your phone calls and thoughts, let's talk first to Mark, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, Mark. Mark in Indy, going once.
Yep,
hey, we got you.
Can you hear me?
Yep, we got you. Go ahead.
Okay. My concern, I'm afraid to hold up my rights. I'll give you the explanation in a moment if you're interested in why.
Mm-hmm.
But first off, I think what would be really cool, what they ought to do, and I don't know why the low-income or the neighborhoods that are targeted by the police, why they're not pushing for this. Why not having a semester class in high school educating the people of their rights when they are approached by a police officer?
Government doesn't want you to know your rights. They're not interested in that.
In other words, we, the people, need to push for that. And if they start fighting that, well, then that's going to open up a lot of skepticism on the people, and that'll actually open up some real good discussions with Congress and congresspeople and all that, too, like in the debates and all that, if we, the people, stand up for that to get our rights. Now, imagine a police officer mistreating a kid out there or a person or myself. I'm 47. But if you got other people out there that understand what's going on and realize that the police officer is screwing that person out there, taking advantage of them, other people might step to the plate, and that police officer might back off.
Yeah, there's a very real possibility of that. I mean, you're not just speculating in my world. In Keene, New Hampshire, where we're doing this show, and in other parts of New Hampshire, we actually have a bunch of activists here who actually do know their rights, and they're willing to stand up for themselves and others. So I've seen situations here, and great call tonight, Mark. Thank you for it. Call us another night and tell us your story. But, I've seen situations where someone will call up. We've got different ways, like Cell 411 is the newest one, but there's some older systems that we've had in the past, like a text messaging system to kind of alert people that something's going on. There's also two-way radios that we use here in Keene. So a call will come out from somebody, and Keene's a small place. It's not hard to get across the city of Keene in 5 minutes by vehicle if the traffic circumstances are right.
Yeah, by no means.
And so it's fairly easy to respond anywhere within Keene. And we've had 8 people show up, a lot of them coming from the same place, but 8 people piling into cars and going to where this person is having an issue with the police pulling them over. And before we'll arrive before the cop actually comes back up to the window. So, they send the alert out as the cop's coming up, takes their ID, cop goes back to the car to look up the ID or whatever, write the ticket or whatever they're going to do back there. And liberty activists arrive, or cop blockers, arrive on the scene before the officer even comes back up to the window. And we've seen officers issue warnings and just, end the stop right there. And not just because it's our friends either. This also happens with people, just normal folks that are on the streets. If Liberty folks or cop blockers happen to encounter that, we'll stop and we'll observe the scene, let the police know that we're there, and let them know that we're keeping an eye on things. And I believe, and I think there's evidence to show, that when you've got people in the public who show concern for their fellow man, even though they're a stranger to them, if they're showing concern and they're standing there and they're watching, the police will treat that person better. The police will be less likely to pull some kind of hanky-panky move of planting drugs or, arresting somebody for some nonsense charge. They're just more likely to end the stop at that point. Doesn't happen all the time. It's not a perfect system. But I think what the gentleman called about is absolutely spot on, that if you show your concern and you know your rights, you can help other people exercise their rights. They'll feel more encouraged because you're there. Again, it doesn't always happen that way. Sometimes people, when they're in the midst of a police pullover, they're embarrassed and they don't want people watching, and they'll tell you to go away. And if somebody wants me to go away, fine. If you want to deal with the police alone, okay, I got other things.
By
I
all
can,
means, yeah.
I got other things I can be doing. But there are some people who genuinely appreciate it, and it is a good way to help people stand up for their rights. And if you want to learn more about that, please go to copblock.org. If you want to get involved with a group of people in your area, you don't have to be in New Hampshire for this. CopBlock is everywhere. It's all around the world. There are CopBlock chapters, I think, in all 50 states and different countries elsewhere. So, and if there's not one near you, you can start one. So copblock.org as we go back to your calls and thoughts. John, listening in Indy to WIBC. Hello, John.
Hey, I enjoy your show.
Excellent. Go ahead with your thoughts.
Well, okay, I'm with perhaps your previous caller questioning basically Fourth Amendment rights. My question is, occasionally I'm in a border state, and I am traveling up, and there is Border Patrol. When they stop you, do they have more rights than does a regular police officer?
At the border, yes. Outside of the border, that's a different story.
No, I'm talking about in our country, you know, within, say, the first 32 miles.
Yeah, you're talking about these checkpoint installations that some are permanent, some are mobile, that do appear, like you're saying, within 100 miles of the northern or southern borders. In theory, they could appear anywhere else, but they just generally do them closer to the border rather than further away. There are some interesting videos online, and again, I don't want to give you legal advice, but there are videos online of people who refuse to answer these Border Patrol questions, and they have differing levels of success with that. You know, there was the one pastor who got pulled from his car and pummeled by the police, but for the most part, it seems to work fairly well with people refusing to answer their intrusive questions. I would say that's one worth looking at a little bit closer and watching how other people approach that, where they just, in a lot of cases, will refuse to answer the question about citizenship. Our co-host, Daryl W. Perry, actually says that he's tried saying "what" over and over again, and he was let go. Hey, thanks for the call tonight, John. Appreciate it, man.
What?
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 Huh?
Oh, God, that's funny.
Yeah, 855-450-FREE. We got time for you.
Your results may vary.
Yeah, we'll get you in here. And be sure you record it so you can put it online.
What?
So we can all learn from your experience. More coming up.
Paid non-attorney spokesperson Adam Pulaski of the Pulaski Law Firm with principal office in Houston, Texas is the attorney responsible for the content of this ad. This ad is not legal advice, and the choice of a lawyer should not be based solely upon advertisement. Services may not be available in all states.
Attention Xarelto users. If you or a loved one took Xarelto and suffered a serious bleeding event, you may be entitled to financial compensation. Xarelto is a popular prescription blood thinner used to prevent blood clots and protect patients from strokes. These serious bleeding events have led to numerous cases of hospitalization and even death. Phone lines are open 24/7. Call 800-261-0937. That's 800-261-0937.
Hi, this is Ted Anderson. Have you ever wondered why banks, stockbrokers, investment advisors won't talk about gold IRAs? They've been available since 1986, yet the financial industry won't recognize the value of gold for your retirement. Gold has outperformed paper investments, yet no word about IRAs. If you would like to have gold for your retirement, call 800-686-2237. Don't get left behind by rising inflation and low returns. Call 800-686-2237. Secure your future and call 1-800-686-2237.
Thousands of people seeking home security get ripped off every day, and the home security industry wants you to believe that's your only option. They've got hordes of salesmen out there trying to scare you into signing one of their long-term contracts. You get stuck writing huge checks month after month with no way out. It's robbery by contract, and it can cost you thousands. But there's a better way to protect your home. SimpliSafe Home Security. SimpliSafe has no contracts. None. You'll get award-winning 24/7 protection. Security professionals watching over your home, ready to instantly send police to the rescue. For just $14.99 per month. That's less than half what most companies charge. Protect your home the smart way. Visit SimpliSafeDefense.com today for an exclusive 10% offer and get a free keychain remote worth $25. Only when you go to SimpliSafeDefense.com. SimpliSafeDefense.com.
Everyone says or does something silly once in a while. But once that embarrassing thing is on the internet, it can spread like a terrible rash. Put it to rest. Get a free expert analysis today from Reputation.com. It only takes 30 seconds. 800-831-0771. We protect your online image by helping to make sure that when people search for you or your business, they find the most current, accurate information possible. Reputation.com. Because word travels fast. Call for a free analysis today. 800-831-0771. That's 800-831-0771. If you owe $10,000 or more to the IRS or state in back taxes, you know they'll never stop coming after you. With bank levies, wage garnishments, they'll even seize your home or business. The good news? A government program for tax debt forgiveness. It's called the Fresh Start Initiative.
I'm Paul Sibley with U.S. Tax Shield. We can help navigate the new laws, get you protected, and resolve your tax issues permanently.
Call the experts at U.S. Tax Shield now for your free consultation and get a guaranteed quote to resolve your case. Call 800-436-6451. That's 800-436-6451.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
Why do over 50% of North Americans suffer from some form of chronic ailment? Could it be due to a toxic overload? It's time to take back your life. Get the lead out as well as the cadmium, mercury, and calcium. Extendovite is a garlic cayenne supplement with five other herbs that acts like a natural Drano, cleaning out the stored toxins, restoring your energy and youthfulness that we've lost. If you would like to live your life free of sickness, pain, or fear, then Extendovite is for you. Available in either capsules or liquid, you too can see why Extendovite is the number one heart drop available. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit our website at heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendovite.
This is Free Talk Live. Call in toll free. 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. Dial toll free and join us here at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-3733. Join us also on Skype at Skype username lrn.fm.
We talk about Bitcoin here on Free Talk Live quite a bit, and you know, you may not know that much about it there, or you may know a great deal about it. Bitcoinist.net is a great site to go for industry news and reviews and education and the latest in cryptocurrency, the cryptocurrency ecosystem. They're a prime online destination for information about Bitcoin and digital currency in the digital currency industry. You can go there and they check it out. Their website integrates a community forum breaking Bitcoin and digital currency news. They also cover fintech and blockchain tech news as well. So they're a great place for both the expert and the beginners. Check them out. If you want Bitcoin news and digital currency news, Bitcoinist.net.
Let's go right to your calls and thoughts. Mike is listening in Panama City to WYOO. Hello, Mike.
Hey, how are you doing tonight?
Welcome, sir. You're on the air. Doing great.
Thank you. Hey, first-time listener. I caught you at the first time flicking on my radio, caught you, and you was talking to, sounded like a police officer who was proud of his drug dogs and teams like that. And, but it sounded like you guys, especially when he wasn't around to say defend himself, but after you got done talking to him, y'all were treating him as if he was like a robotic Nazi kind of guy just out just to harass everybody in the whole wide world.
I thought I defended him.
Now, the other guy. Well, what about the other guy?
You said you guys. I mean, there's two of us here. We have different opinions.
Yeah.
Well, I don't think I treated him like a robotic Nazi, but he was the one claiming that it was his job to enforce the law. And I told him that he actually, what I told him was he has discretion, which by definition would mean he's not a robotic Nazi. Discretion is the police's option to enforce the law.
But he told you that he would arrest a guy for the 1 kilo. He used his discretion. He said he would arrest him.
Yeah.
So he did use his discretion.
He could also use his discretion to not arrest. He could also use his. He could also be a good human being and not arrest people who haven't hurt anybody else.
I know that's what killed me. When you talk about the people who get pulled over, the civilian, y'all talk to them like they're good human beings, but you seem to forget that good human beings are police officers too, right?
Sure. That's what I said. He could be a good human being, and he could not arrest peaceful people who haven't hurt anybody else. Wouldn't that be what a good human being does?
No, he used his good human being discretion to arrest a guy. And you should have said, oh, good to go.
No, excuse me. How can you be a good human being by putting someone in a cage who has not ever hurt another person?
Are we a country of laws or not?
No, we're not.
We're not.
No,
okay.
You're not. Did Charlie Rangel go to prison for fudging his tax returns? Have you ever seen a police officer pull over another police officer for rolling through a stoplight? No, we are not a country of laws.
See,
there are laws
thing,
that are
though.
Only
see,
for civilians. You've got to, in order to be a country of laws, the politicians and the police officers have to be susceptible to them.
Yeah. Okay, you're on the radio all the time, so you can talk all the time. So let me talk just a little bit.
I was just backing up my statement.
No, but Charlie Rangel and all that other stuff, okay, they got out of it, okay? That's true. They did do it. But everybody that I'm at the stoplight with, we're stopping at the stoplight because it's a law to stop at the stoplight.
Yes, the serfs have to obey the law. I agree with you.
We are a country of laws.
The serfs have to obey the – no, this is not a country of laws.
No,
in a country of laws, every human being has to obey the laws. We are in a class-based system, and you are the lowest portion, unless you're a cop who hasn't mentioned it yet.
You have never been outside this country, have you?
I have been to two dozen countries.
No, well
– And I would say it's not much better elsewhere, except in Europe they really don't have the drug war.
Have you been to Saudi Arabia? Have you been to India? Have you been anywhere?
No. Saudi Arabia and India are
really
been
to two dozen countries.
I said I've been to two dozen countries.
You don't understand the way the world works, man. You don't
What do we not understand? Lay it down, brother.
Yeah.
Let's hear it.
Okay. Let me know.
All right. So, I got online one time. Y'all was talking about the New Hampshire group that y'all belong to. So I was not associated with this. I didn't know you were on. I just turned on the radio. But I watched a group, white rights watchers like you guys, and y'all got up, pre-planned this whole thing, and you got people to get chalk and write on a federal building, right? And you stand way back off to the side to film the police officers and the federal marshals or whoever they are to film them to do this.
When was this, right? And where was this?
You are antagonist. Oh, go online. You're Freedom Watch people.
Well, I don't know who Freedom Watch. I don't know who Freedom Watch.
You're saying y'all, and I don't.
Yeah, I don't know who Freedom Watch is. I
watched a video.
There was a video out of, was it New Hampshire?
You guys. What happens is you intentionally set the cops up. You set them up and you film them and you watch this good human being, the police officer, the good human being, and y'all push them and you push them. And you push them. And every human being, even a good human being guy like you who's in the media, because you guys all walk on water, y'all never do anything fuzzy. Okay?
Jeez,
y'all,
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not part of the media, dude.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so sitting.
Yeah, you are. You're on
somebody
the talk radio.
Sitting
you're
here
on the radio, man.
You're on the radio. You are, by definition, part
of
the media.
All right, well, you callers are a bunch of morons. I mean, I don't know what the hell
that
means.
That's how you think.
Look, no, that's not what I think at all.
Well, then don't
I
say
think
it,
that
Mark.
You are an individual making a telephone call to me, an individual.
Yeah.
I am not part of the media. Walter Cronkite doesn't call me.
You are part of the media.
I never get a listen, I've never had a memo from any organization telling me what to say.
Yeah.
I am not the media.
Yes, you are. You're on the radio.
Yes,
by definition,
you
you're part of the media.
So's
Stop
he. He's
it.
On the radio, too.
Yeah, but the cops are good human beings.
I'm not saying
they're not.
So
you can't make a general statement like that. Some cops are bad human beings. Some of them are hurting peaceful people.
Some radio hosts are bad human beings, too.
I guess that's
me. No doubt about it.
I'm a bad human being.
No doubt about it. Let's go back to the chalking, though. I want to talk about that. So the chalking.
Yeah.
I don't necessarily disagree with chalking on the side of a building, but I've never seen anybody chalk the side of a federal building in New Hampshire. There were some people. One of them was arrested, I believe, for chalking on the outside, on like the sidewalk outside of the federal buildings here.
On the building.
Yeah.
All right.
And the cops were so great. They were so great. They said, you know, hey, don't do this, blah, 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 blah. And they said, please turn off the camera. And the guy said, well, I'm backing up. And he kept backing away from the cop, acting like he's walking on the sidewalk. He's filming the cop the whole time. You're just needling that good human being.
Yeah. Look, man, they're professionals. They're paid a lot of money to act like professionals.
Thanks for the call, Mike. Appreciate hearing from you tonight. I'm
sorry.
You know,
I could have liked this guy, but he was frustrating as hell. You're the one who goes and antagonizes police and does all this stuff.
I don't antagonize
the police. Whatever. You're the one who films police. I don't do any of that stuff. That guy is a jackhole. I mean, he's just making blanket claims about people. I got no use for that dude.
Well, look, as far as recording the police is concerned, I don't consider that to be antagonizing anybody. I understand there's a certain set of people out there, let's call them copsuckers, who, you know, they'll agree with everything the police do. There's nothing the police can do wrong.
They
in
love
those
themselves
people's
a uniform,
minds.
No doubt.
And they, you know, they feel like it's harassing and threatening and intimidating to pull out a video camera and record government agents, whether it be the police or the parking enforcers or whoever it is that is a government agent, to record them in the process of doing their job. And I'm sorry, that is not harassing. And it is being a good person to stand up for your rights. These police, when they're aggressing against peaceful people, which is what their job is day in and day out, every now and then they'll actually stop a real criminal from hurting somebody else, and I support them when they do that. But when they're out there harassing college students for open container, when they're harassing hippies for smoking pot, when they're harassing little old ladies for going 10 miles over the speed limit, that's when they're no longer a good person. If you're stopping somebody and you're arresting them, you're stopping their freedom of motion for no real victim, when there's no actual victim who's been harmed, you are not being a good human being. Well, by
being
definition.
A good human being. But that doesn't mean you not are not a human good human being.
That's moment, you are not being a good person. If you're
it's a
hurting
behavior issue.
If you're hurting a peaceful person. 855-450-FREE is our toll-free number. If you're on the line right now, we're going to do our best to get you on the air. The remaining moments of Free Talk Live are coming up on this live Saturday edition.
Every once in a while, you get information that's worth changing your life for. This is one such time. You can save up to and beyond 25% on all purchases at Amazon. You probably heard of Bitcoin and just not thought much about it. You certainly know that you can get competitive pricing at Amazon, but now you can get a 25% discount on nearly everything you need to live. I've just given you a huge raise, and all you have to do is claim it. You go to purse.freetalklive.com and open an account. Do this right now, don't wait. Then you fund the account with Bitcoin. You can buy them through expresscoin.com with a check or money order. There are other ways to get Bitcoin, but that's fast, safe, and easy. This information is worth you changing the way you do things. Go to purse.freetalklive.com right now and get signed up and cash in on the huge raise I'm offering you. 25% off of everything on Amazon through purse.freetalklive.com. It's purse.freetalklive.com.
Would you like to use your IRA funds to buy precious metals and hold them at home? Are you wary of the stock market, paper gold, or faraway depositories? With a checkbook IRA, you may legally take custody of IRA-owned gold and silver. Visit checkbookira.com and learn how IRA owners in all 50 states have already taken control. Checkbookira.com. Checkbookira.com.
This is Dan Pilla. Do you owe the IRS money you can't pay? Are tax debts crippling you? I've defended people from the IRS for over 30 years. I've helped thousands, and I can help you too. I wrote the book on IRS settlement, and I'm telling you, there's no such thing as a hopeless case. Call 800-34-NO-TAX to finally get free of IRS debt. With the IRS's new programs, there's never been a better time to solve your problem. Call 800-34-NO-TAX. That's 800-34-NO-TAX or my website, danpilla.com.
On the average, Americans work between 45 to 50 years, hoping to build up enough wealth to retire and live out their golden years. Unfortunately, with taxation, the rising cost of food, energy, housing, and medical, many retirees are forced to live below the poverty line. Is this a flaw for enterprise, or is our monetary unit we call the Federal Reserve Note forcing us into perpetual debt, ensuring inflation and higher taxes? These questions and more can be answered by reading G. Edward Griffin's book, The Creature from Jekyll Island. Congressman Ron Paul states it's what every American needs to know about central bank power. A gripping adventure into the secret world of international banking cartel. Hi, this is Ted Anderson. I will give a silver dollar from the early 1900s to anyone who purchases this book. Call 1-800-686-2237 and order a copy today. It's critical that the public be made aware of the system. Call and order your copy today at 1-800-686-2237. That's 1-800-686-2237.
Gold, it's like nothing else on Earth. From the Romans through the Renaissance, from the Industrial Age to the Space Age, gold has weathered the test of time. For 6,000 years, gold has remained the ultimate store of wealth. According to the World Gold Council and the U.S. Mint, demand is at an all-time high. The stage is being set for the reemergence of gold as the common-sense alternative to a fiat paper currency that gets weaker every day. Midas Resources is proud to offer the hard-hitting report that arms you with the truth you need to protect you and your family from the Fed's plans for your hard-earned money. Don't gamble with your future. Call Midas Resources today and ask for your free copy of As Good as Gold. Call 1-800-686-2233. For the report the Fed hopes you'll never see. As Good as Gold can be yours by calling 800-686-2237. If you have ever thought about owning gold, you must read this report. Call Midas today at 800-686-2237.
You're listening to Free Talk Live. Call in toll free at 855-450-FREE. That's 855-450-FREE.
It's Free Talk Live. Moments remain here. If you're already on the line, we're going to get you on here if we possibly can. If you don't make it in tonight, don't worry. We do this show 7 nights a week. So you got a live Sunday edition coming up tomorrow, 7 to 10 at night Eastern Time. Those are our live hours. If you're not listening live, maybe you're listening on a radio station that does what they call in the business delay broadcast, you can still call us during the live hours, and then you can hear yourself later on. So be sure to join us tomorrow. We got plenty of time for you then.
You can also listen, if you want to hear yourself, we have archives that are available right at the main page at freetalklive.com, and you can go get, you know, this is what you should do.
It's more fun to listen on the radio, though, Mark.
I agree. Yeah. The radio is a magic, it's a magic box.
Right. So also, the audio that I promised you tonight, which we're not going to get to, I want to do tomorrow night. I told John and Kat, Kat Bleich Bush, the Bush Bleich folks from Austin, that we're going to put their audio on the air. They got pulled over recently. And just as an example of some people who do know their rights, you know, how do they interact with the police, especially when they've got the kids in the car, which some would say is going to change how you interact with the police. And so I'll save that for tomorrow night. We'll get back to your phone calls and thoughts here. Let's go first to Larry, listening in St. George, Utah, KZNU. Hello, Larry.
Hey. I think people need to realize just how them dogs are trained. They're hyperactive dogs, and they will chew on a piece of paper, gum wrapper on the ground that's never had anything to do with drugs, and nail you for probable cause. So they really need to realize the type of dog and how they're getting detained, and of course smell something in the car, and then the dog chews on the car, and then they're searching the car. So
yeah, it's basically walking probable cause. Probable cause on a leash, essentially, is these these dogs, as Radley Balco pointed out.
Well, fake probable cause.
Well,
you know,
right.
Whether you've done anything or not, they're going to cue on something.
Yep, and then they're going to do their best to find something you've done wrong, even if they don't find drugs. They'll try to find something they can
charge
you with.
Probable cause. If you don't have it, we'll create it.
Larry, thanks for the call tonight, man. Let's talk to, I believe we've got Kenneth in Charlottesville. Kenneth, you're on Free Talk Live.
Hey, first off, let me say, talking about police overstepping their bounds, when I was 19... Well, actually 17, I had a car accident and had the police officer come to my high school and pull me out of class and interview me for the accident, which, you know, being 17, being a minor, I don't know how well that went. But my question was, I've looked at a lot of YouTube videos of people being stopped and refusing to roll down their window,
mm-hmm.
and I was wondering, you know, how that, you know, kind of acts out. I mean,
this, well, you, you've seen, you know, the videos. How did it go in the videos?
The registration without the I'm sorry, what's that?
Oh, you said you'd seen a bunch of videos. How did it go for the people in the videos when they refused to roll down?
Some police officers just let them go. Some of the videos, they
drag them out of the car.
Yeah. So, right, your mileage may vary.
That's it.
I personally like the approach. I think it's generally a good one. It's a good way to show that officer right off the bat that you're someone who knows your rights and you're going to be exercising them. But that doesn't mean you won't encounter a rogue cop who's more than happy to smash your window and then, you know, grab your phone, throw it on the ground, and then proceed to beat you. But you could, you know, he could do that anyway, right? Like, so even if you rolled your window down, you might do something else that guy doesn't like.
In my car, I have the Freedom Cam. It's at freedomcam.net, and it is recording what goes on in the vehicle at all times, and I have control of the recording.
Well, that's right. True, unless they smash the device.
The question is, you know, how do you identify yourself to a police officer without rolling your window down? Because, you know, the argument was, once you roll your window down, they can say, well, I smelled something, and then that gives them access to do whatever they want.
Yeah, that's true. And that is a good reason to not roll your window down. There are people who will just slip the license and the registration right through the crack of the top of the window. And again, it's a crapshoot. You know, you never know how an officer is going to respond. If you're in an area where you've got a real problem with rogue cops who are violent and dangerous, then this could be something that sets them off. But on the other hand, if you're recording the scene, that helps protect you. And, you know, that same cop that could be set off by you not rolling your window down may be set off by you recording video of him in the first place. So anything you do to flex your rights at one of these stops could be the excuse that a rogue cop uses to commence a beating on you. But that's not a reason to not flex your rights. I think it's more important to do these things than to not do them, although there are certainly risks involved. Kenneth, thanks for your call tonight. Let's go to Wayne, listening in Missouri. You're on Free Talk Live. Wayne with the Ian and Mark.
Hi, yes. I appreciate you accepting my call.
Does this say here you're listening via satellite, Wayne?
Yes, I am. Galaxy 19 on Star 6.
You just made Ian's day.
Excellent.
I want you to know.
Thank you, Wayne. Appreciate you tuning in up there. Go ahead.
Very good. I was beat in 1988 by a rogue cop. Had my head beat by a razor baton. I sued, won $1 million, and they took bankruptcy on me back in that day. They could get out from underneath the civil damage and things like that. A couple years later, two cops hired by the same city lied and said I threatened to kill a circuit judge. They gave me 3 years in Department of Corrections for tampering with a judicial official and branded me a felon for life. There's no such thing as protection and doing everything right and perfect here in this country. Each situation is a situation in and of itself.
Mm.
And your legal stuff, the bars, if you're not a member of the Bar Association, you're not in the clique. If you're not a police officer, you're not in their clique. Most people aren't educated enough to read and write and understand the laws and principles and stuff, and there's so much legal jargon. The first rule in any court is Rule 1, the judge rules his court, no matter what the laws are in this land.
You're not joking. I'd like to point out that you really can go online and look at the New Hampshire District Court rules. Rule 1.1, the first rule, is that the judge can waive the rules at any time in the so-called interests of justice. So there are no rules. That's what rule number one literally says. It's not a joke. You're absolutely right, Wayne. And I think you're bringing a good point up, and that is that if they want you, they can get you. It doesn't matter if you know your rights.
One way or another, it doesn't really matter. But I also hold that if you're a citizen, a sovereign citizen, I might add, claiming that you uphold the laws of the country, you don't have to break the laws to take and be a part of their little clique. I hold my head up. I walk down the street. I talk to my friends. I may be economically disadvantaged, but I have a pretty good education, and I hold myself proud. I got a case in the court right now involving a civil matter with my wife.
You'll have to call another night and tell us about that if you want. Wayne, thanks for your call tonight.
Right.
You know, I appreciate where he's coming from. Certainly, if they want to get you, they can concoct some kind of nonsense and bring the power and the force of the state against you and ruin your life. Even if ultimately they fail with the charges, they will still destroy your life by bankrupting you and, you know, ruining your ability to, you know, go about your daily business because you're constantly defending yourself in court. So from that perspective, that's something you need to consider. But all things considered, overall, standing up for your rights collectively is a good idea. Individually, it could result in you being targeted for further retaliation by corrupt police. There's no doubt about that. But overall, if more of us do it, it helps keep the police in line and it helps them be more respectful of everyone if they know that there's a chance they're being recorded or they're dealing with somebody who knows their rights. So it's not to say that you shouldn't exercise your rights. There are risks involved, but to me, the risks are worth it because if you just cower and you just do what you're told and you never stand up for yourself, then you are definitely going to be further enslaved over time. There's no doubt about that.
All of us will, yeah.
All right, so you got to stand up sometime. Let's go to Dave, listening in California. Dave, you're on Free Talk Live. Real short on time. Go quick.
Some police are very fair, reasonable, conscientious, and I know some. And some police are hotheads, abusive, and prone to misuse their power. So we can't go into the encounter with a prior assumption. We have to be open. One rule for me is if it gets ugly, I don't want it to be me that initiates it. You know, I want to be reasonable and civil myself and open to the idea this cop just may be doing an honest job.
Yeah, definitely. You want the cop to be the ugly one in a situation like that. Good point, Dave. Let's talk to, and thanks for the call. Let's talk to William in Indy, listening to WIBC. Hello, William.
Hello.
You're on the air, but you're short on time, so go quick.
Oh, I just wanted to share a traffic stop that I had about 6 months ago.
Okay.
I recently moved to a new county, and I didn't know that I had to renew my plates entirely. They were still valid, but I was pulled over. And the reason they gave me was, coming home from work, he said I was weaving over the center lane a little bit. He took my license, and the very next words out of his mouth were, is it okay if I search your vehicle?
Mm.
And it just really floored me. I was just totally unprepared. There's no probable cause given, and I didn't know my rights, so I just told him no, but I will wait for you to get a warrant.
Oh, man, I wish we had time for this whole story. Can you call us tomorrow night, William, because we are out of time for tonight.
7 p.m. Eastern.
7 p.m. Eastern. We'd love to hear back from you then. I want to make sure you have time to tell the whole thing, which you don't have time for
now.
So we'll see you tomorrow night. FreeTalkLive.com in the meantime.
If worse comes to worst, will you be prepared? You don't have to be a survivalist to prepare for the unexpected. Storing necessary supplies like food, water, and emergency equipment is simply taking responsibility for ourselves and our families when it counts the most. StrategicShelters.com offers emergency supplies and a secure way to store them, and provides protection for loved ones in the event of an extreme natural or man-made disaster. To find out more, visit StrategicShelters.com.
DVD, books, music, instruments, periodicals, computers, software, electronics, photo, cell phone, office products, home and garden, bed and bath, furniture, kitchen, pet supplies, automotive, hardware, apparel, shoes.